Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Iron Keep Chronicles. Sorry for the late start. We've had some technical difficulties with our stream. One big technical difficulty named Havana Mahoney. Did you know that every person in this room is in retrograde?
Yeah, Pluto's in retrograde, bitch. Get your shit together.
It's actually good advice.
That kind of
I'll read it to chat. Chat wants to know about
our
Pluto.
Dear friend, Mr. Kyle Capps, is swamped by the deadline monster, so he will be battling his
Why. Is it because Pluto's in retrograde?
No, it's because he spent all of his time drawing a goat with a nice butt.
You know that he did that in 5 minutes because he's a wizard.
Wizard.
It was 5 minutes he didn't have.
Because of Pluto.
That's an entire episode of Thundercats that he missed because he spent 5 minutes doing that.
Is he working on Thundercats?
Stop!
We're not supposed to talk about it because people are mean about it.
People are mean about it, it's true.
They are.
That's true. People
well,
are.
Maybe he's.
The wrong people are dicks about it. We know that you're the right people because you're watching our show. Thanks so much for joining us. I am your host and a dungeon master, Mr. Tom Lommel. Back from the grave of narcolepsy and clogged lungage. Lungage? Is that, that's not really a word, is it?
I liked it.
Yeah.
I'll approve.
Clogged lungage.
Are you looking for validation from me?
I'm just looking for pity. I'm sure I've got it from you. Big thanks to Mr. J Africa for jumping in at the last minute last week and kicking things off.
Gosh,
and
I miss Jay.
So, hey, you know what?
He was so nice to us. Yeah.
Let me tell you what's great about Jay is Jay's coming back next week while I'm in Canada.
Suspicious.
So
suspicious.
Yeah, so that's
just like his Canadian wife.
Yeah. That he has sex with on Sundays.
What is said before stream stays before stream.
I already pulled out all the Pluto and retrograde bullshit, so
that's
I'm going to pull out your bullshit.
All right.
You hey, want your
everyone.
Bullshit out here?
Sure. Sure, me and Midnight Amy will talk about bullshit.
Yes, there was like, get in touch with your shadow self, the one that's lurking in the shadows, and I was like, yes, I know who that is. I call her Midnight Amy, which is true. Midnight Amy has been surfacing recently.
Oh my god.
Look out.
One of my dear friends, Mr. Ryan Macklin, who is a erstwhile game designer and whatnot. He had two Twitter accounts, and one was for him, and then one was for him when he'd been drinking. So maybe
I don't go that far.
Not a bad idea. So, we've got a cavalcade of exciting things happening this evening. You can see it all if you do exclamation point unlocks or exclamation point tips. You can see what you can donate to tonight's game. We're going to kick things off with a big combat since we were cliffhangered last week by Mr. J Africa. But let's quick, you know our players, let's introduce them anyhow. Let them have a chance to say what they want to say as opposed to just batting the ball back at me. Amy Vorpal, everyone.
I'd like you to say who I am.
Amy Vorpal is an award-winning actress, improviser, and talent, and we are blessed to have her each and every week here on the Iron Keep Chronicles.
All right. I don't know how to respond to that, so I'm just going to be snarky.
He always does that. He always takes you with the surprise compliment.
Sincere praise.
Wow.
That's the hook.
Great. I'm playing, and who am I playing?
You're
Tax Sully Pond.
Oh, that's right. You're the giant
Arky-barky
that still doesn't have a boyfriend.
Boyfriend.
I mean, fairy. Okay, we all get it. It's just, you know.
Did you even watch the Mamma Mia episode?
Oh my god.
Huh? That's called whiplash, everybody. Wham!
Ouchie,
I thought you threw that fry at Amy.
Take that.
Dang.
Clean that up, Dom.
I was like, yes, that's an expensive
dress. Her name is Lowstorm. She's a Goliath and a giant, and I guess she doesn't have a boyfriend.
Does she have a boyfriend?
No, she's got
no,
a betrothed back.
Oh,
she's
that's
got a
right.
betrothed back at home, but yeah. We don't really.
Is your betrothed Canadian?
She's a fairy before she can get betrothed. She's one-track minded at the moment.
Ah, I see. Okay. Yeah. So before she can get married, she has to fulfill her.
Before a lot of things can happen, she needs a fairy. Yeah.
She's got priorities.
Well, now I'm curious what some of these lot of other things are.
Mainly get married.
Get a mani-pedi.
And also not get kicked out of her clan.
Oh, yeah.
The laundry's piling up, but she doesn't have a fairy yet.
Right.
You're not legally allowed to play goat ball if you don't have a fairy.
Oh my gosh.
Wait, she did. That's
not breaking the law, breaking the law, breaking the law.
Is not a criminal, but she will play goat ball illegally.
That is not canon.
Yeah,
stop.
Not canon.
It is now Go my ball. Goal to make Lowstorm a criminal before the end of the adventure.
You have too many goals. Like, leave off Lowstorm. She's had it hard enough.
Leave her off.
Leave off her.
I just enjoy the fact that I've been given this opportunity for Amy to say whatever she wants without having to respond to me, and the whole thing is just, man, what's wrong with you? Why are you doing this to me?
I know. Well, you said that, and I was like, I'm not going to do that. Keep playing this
you
game.
Can't tell me what to do. Hey, speaking of you can't tell me what to do, Van Mahone.
Oh, you can tell me all you want, but that doesn't mean I'll fucking do it.
Don't do it.
Don't try.
Yeah. I actually...
You will suffer the wrath. We have seen it.
Yeah, it's lovely. Yeah. You tell Havana what to do. That...
What was I was?
Wait, what are you referring to?
I guess it's more me, but that night at the apartment.
Oh yeah, let's not talk about that.
That night at the apartment could be anything.
Could
really.
Be anything.
I killed someone.
I was watching last week, and I think there was something like somewhere along somebody was like, "Hey, we should investigate these bodies," and the man was just like, "What have I been saying for the past 20 minutes?" It was just
oh yeah, that was
we should.
It was some classic.
That was 2 episodes ago.
Yeah.
Classic Havana Rage.
Where I was like, mm-hmm. "Oh no, that was last episode."
Mm-hmm.
Where I was like, "Oh, we should do some investigation," and you and Kyle were just like, no, let's decorate the course.
I was yes anding.
Okay, well, there's improv, and then there's, like, tactical role-playing.
And then I did suboptimal role-play, and I just poked him with a stick. And
which was also my idea. I didn't get to do any of it. I just had to deal with all the consequences. Yeah.
If there's one thing that you would like your character to do tonight, what would it be?
He's gonna He's gonna try to thwart it.
Say make Amy a criminal. Say make Amy
I don't understand that, and I don't agree with it.
All right.
Also, I think technically we probably are all already criminals.
Oh.
I mean, we've never been... I mean,
we've killed people.
But it's
things.
A very lawless area. There is no
sure.
law here.
Right, but by... I mean, if we're talking about criminals, I mean, that could be under anybody's standards.
I mean,
a criminal in the forest could
hearts.
Maybe be, a, by the same standards, a criminal in the city. If they knew what we had done in the forest, we might still be held accountable for that. Anyway, all right. It's fine.
Semantics.
Semantics. Yeah, I don't know. I saw a picture of a cat person, so I just want to be a cat person's best friend.
I like that. Oh, okay. Very good.
Wait, you did?
On his Twitter.
Yeah, I don't tag you in my DM posts. Mm-hmm.
You said, I did see that you had a book full, you said I have a few creatures, and it's like, got 25 tabs.
Yeah, whatever. Mm.
That's too many.
Mm. Wait, what has 25 tabs?
A book where he's like, I found creatures to throw at the party tonight.
I made
and
some
it's,
selections
it's like
from
25,
the...
25
no, that's like when you open a catalog and trying to figure out what you want for Christmas
no,
and
but
you
he
circle
had Dom,
everything in red.
He had Dom print them out. He was just handing him like page numbers and codes.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
That's scary.
SSRI 49ers!
1168! I'm not sure what the significance is.
Oh, because they are in Germany and.
Oh, that's.
And
that's,
it's a translation.
That's the, oh, that's like 8 euros or whatever.
Yeah, it's something.
Yeah,
conversion.
Awesome.
Yeah, conversion, not
Thank
translation.
You. SF Giants 49.
German money said turn into American money.
Is that the,
I don't know
is,
how to
is
say
that
German
the same
money.
Person as Siamath Pirnikov? Or is that. No, it's
no,
somebody else.
Different.
Look at all these German fans we have.
You were just surprised two Germans
were Yeah, I think that's awesome. I spent a year
There's
German.
Only like
I
seven
it.
People in Germany.
Oh, you did?
So that's weird.
I'm doing German Duolingo. I think I've mentioned it before.
You mentioned it last week, as a matter of fact.
Yeah.
That was
You said one phrase five times.
A
it
treasure.
Was great.
Ich habe eine Katze.
Oh, yeah. No, ich habe keine Katze, which means I don't have a cat.
You don't have any cat.
Yeah. Oh, that's what you said?
There's one thing
No, I said
Check
I have,
again.
I said I have a, I have a
oh.
cat.
Happy birthday.
I don't know how to say that.
Mr. Eric Reichert, what foreign languages do you speak?
I speak a little Japanese. I whispered Japanese to Amy at midnight. And,
we were all, me and Havana, Stephen Pope, and Eric, were all lying quietly in our beds listening to Eric.
I kept saying, I love you, Amy, in Japanese.
And I kept repeating it back.
Yeah.
And then, well, but angrily. And then I was in the middle of the both of them just weeping.
So here's what I've learned is that Midnight Amy speaks Japanese.
She doesn't.
No,
it was,
no,
no,
it was
no.
bad. To the point where I'm like, never do this in public. Never, ever, ever try and speak Japanese in front of people.
There were some, you know, there were some patterns of speech that I really held on to.
Very good, very good. So the we Texas play the Dungeons and Dragons 5th edition here every Wednesday night. Who would like to give a succinct recap of Jay's
Kyle's
excursion
not here.
Last
Kyle's
week?
Not here. All right, yeah. So Havrick, we started off, we're on the back of Havrick's cart as he had just stolen the giant chest from the Minotaur Chaos Outbreak. And then he starts telling us about the Green Shredders, who are this clan of wood elves that are in the area that we need to go to get to our destination.
Yes.
And he's like, no, I'm not fucking doing that. Y'all can go by yourselves, that's fine. And then we have a little bit of a camp, but while we're camping...
I made a beautiful map.
Is that a new one?
You're going,
no.
You're
oh,
going
okay.
This way.
I was like, what do you mean?
Mm-hmm. You're going this way. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Through the Green Shredder territory.
And eventually you want to end up a little north of there, at the foot of those mountains.
Well, yeah, you're already sort of a little bit too far. You're already kind of into this territory here, so you've sort of skirted them a little south.
Well, why'd we do that?
No, we didn't. No, we didn't. Because
why'd
we asked Jay if it was on our way, and he said yes.
Okay. All right.
Jay said that we didn't do anything wrong and we're the best.
And he said that we don't have to go to bed until we want to.
And Jay said, he said we have as many M&Ms as we want.
Yeah.
No, he didn't. But he
and
did
we can
say,
watch
already
movies.
100.
Okay. All right. As long as you don't call long distance, everything's
also
fine.
Also, he said I can have one booby mag a week.
Okay, but you're going to have to go in the woods.
Only me.
Yeah.
I'll give you a page of the bad one.
But the rest
it's
of us,
an ad.
The rest of us get the three triple, the big consoles, the big video game consoles. Dad.
You rip out the essays.
That's what Jay said.
All right. You get an Intellivision, you get a ColecoVision, and you get the Atari 5200.
What year is it, Tom? Please tell me, because it doesn't seem like you know.
Keep There's going. A lot of things I'm on the short list of. Let's continue our recap.
Then we're on camp. Amy turned into a goat.
With a great butt.
With a very cool butt, and she got stuck up on a big root. It's so stupid. And then while she was stuck, it refused to turn back into her regular self, so we all wandered off and found these carvings glowing in the trees of the script, which ended up being elven, older elven, or I guess wood elf elven,
yeah,
which is a
some
little
sort
different.
Of like old dialect.
But we decided that they were like warding symbols or like alarm symbols. So then, thank you, Zather.
Thank you, Zather.
After our and then we head out, and then the forest gets really quiet, and we see these figures that's like a human-sized one, and then this like bigger one that turns out to be a displacer beast.
Right.
And
yes, there's a clearing with some dead things kind of in it.
But then when we approach them, these like black ichor monsters come out and try to fuck with us because low storm.
No, it didn't have anything to do with me. I druid crafted flowers on it. But that was strategic too, to make it look like we gave a shit about their green treader friend who fell in battle, clearly. Thanks, Jonana.
Well,
so you fought the weird necrotic ooze pile monsters that came up out of the ground.
Killed them.
Killed them dead.
Dagon.
And then were rapidly encircled by
green
wood
treaders.
Elves.
Green
treaders.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, also we burn the bodies.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, they're not coming back.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. And then Zariesta.
Hello, hi.
Yes!
Callback. Zariestra.
Zariestra. Tra, the leader of the
Tra-la-la.
Green treaders. And made a deal with them.
She's the second in command. You didn't actually learn the name of the leader.
Didn't we?
No, he refused to. You didn't really press for his name. And
also, he doesn't speak common to us.
Mm-hmm. I just assumed the woman was in charge. That's very sexist of me.
In fact, kind of the only reason that you were able to win the Green Traders over to your side at all is because Alton spoke some halting, or at least they speak a very old form of Elvish, and he spoke Elvish to them.
That wasn't the only reason.
It's a big part of it.
Didn't Havana make a really good case? Yeah.
Later, yeah. Oh. Yes. Sorry, continue. What? did I say?
You're just always downplaying my achievements.
What? When did I downplay what you're doing?
I got you. It's fine. I got you.
I'm sorry. It started with, there was an opening created when Eric spoke Elvish, and then you put the icing on the cake by...
I put the icing in that hole he created.
Thursday night.
Thursday?
That just sounds like a Thursday night.
You've never been Thursday night ice holing?
Just watching Critical Role and putting icing in my hole.
That's our catchphrase. Welcome to Critical Role. Put icing in that hole.
Be Jaloo, thank you.
Let's not get like...
Are you already delirious?
I came in here broken. All
right. Okay. The whole table's in retrograde. Did I mention that?
Oh, Pluto, why?
Yeah, Pluto's fucking crazy in retrograde.
Dude, it's fucking shit. We just all have to look inside ourselves and find our shadow selves.
It's, yeah.
And we have to acknowledge them, and then we have to change them.
I call that person 10:30 Tom, mostly because I go to bed early.
Midnight Amy.
I want to know what my
shadow selves are. Do you know where I got Midnight Amy from? I was recruiting nurses, and there was a guy named Lorenzo, and I was recruiting him, and blah, 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 and then, and on the phone, I was like, all right, great.
I'm sorry, what do you mean by, what's recruiting nurses?
It was a job I had.
You had a job?
I was headhunting.
Here in L.A.?
Yeah. For 7, 8 years.
What? Recruiting nurses?
Yeah.
Okay.
Anyway.
Wait, like real nurses or like movie nurses?
No, not casting. Really, like people who are going to work in nursing homes. Anyway, I'm going to get his resume, but I'm like, what's your email? I'll send you an email. You can reply to it. And he goes, well, it's Midnight Lorenzo, like 5-6. I was like, what? Like, I don't know. It was not at Gmail. It was like at a different, either Yahoo or AOL. Yeah, something like that. And I was like, what is this? You sound like a superhero. You're Midnight Lorenzo. He was like, yeah, I just thought it sounded cool. And I'm like,
you're right.
I mean, you're right, and I'm going to steal it.
Right. Yeah, he probably didn't really want to tell you why he was actually called that. Then we talk a little bit about how the death of the Grand Druid has caused all these repercussions, and there's an eye sigil in the bodies we determine is the symbol of the Waste Lady. And she's over in the old ruins that used to belong to the Wood Elves.
Okay.
And then I've written something completely illegible here. I think it says library. Yes. Radidibadidi to the evil gods.
There's a...
Library dead dated.
Dedicated.
Oh.
Dedicated to the evil gods.
I didn't leave room for all the letters.
Yes, it was explained to you that the reason that they haven't been able to defeat the Waste Lady is that she is nesting, whatever that means, in a cursed library that has been dedicated to the evil gods. So your plan was to dress Alton up as an elf and send him out as bait and follow at a reasonable distance.
And then we abandoned him.
but she got wise, apparently, because as we're doing like a horseshoe around Alton, she's offing the wood elves.
Yeah.
So now we're reconvening, as we're reconvening,
I shot.
Jay made
a bunch of statues started crying. So I
no, they
shoot
didn't.
Them.
They didn't start crying. That was
they started gooping.
Thing.
They didn't goop.
Yeah,
they were gooping.
They were gooping. Like it like moved, and then arm started gooping. I was like, well, I'm gonna shoot it.
Yeah, and that's when it ended. That's when everything.
That's
ended.
Right.
That's when Jay ended.
Very good. So if you sub up to the stream, you get to donate a reroll to somebody here at the table.
Me.
Myself included.
No.
So,
everyone but me.
Boo.
So let's take care of some of that. Be right UK.
No. Make them all go to Eric.
Gives their reroll to.
Oh, Eric, you deserve it.
I don't.
You work so hard.
I don't work very hard.
In fact.
Havana Mahoney.
Yay.
Oh, I have two from last week too.
Ooh.
The Posh Panda sends their reroll to Havana Mahoney.
Oh, so this is Posh Panda. Who is the other one?
Zathier.
Oh, thank you guys so much.
And Be Right UK all send their rerolls to Havana Mahoney.
You guys, thank you.
Is this
the
new
one?
Thanks, guys.
I thought you were like, is this for me?
No, I was just going to say it's.
And then let me check.
I think he just never passes them out.
Because there were some yesterday during disorganized play.
There were?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, the air conditioning's here.
Two Let me just scroll back here to all of my
G unit.
Over here.
One reroll. Thomas W. DeYoung sends one reroll each to Amy Vorpal.
Yay! Wow. Thank you, Thomas W. DeYoung.
And Eric Reichert.
Yeah.
Not worth it. Not worth it. Waste of time.
In addition, thanks to some of your generous donations here, the table gets inspiration.
Yay!
Sounded fake, Amy.
Yeah. Jay!
That's you.
No, I am very excited.
It's like Monty Python. It's like the Holy Grail.
You said that even less exciting. You fell asleep while saying, no, I'm very excited.
Also, thanks to the generous donations of everyone in chat, everybody gets a reroll, including me.
I don't like that one bit.
Yeah, you gotta chill out, Tom.
No.
What's your deal?
What is your major malfunction, bro?
I didn't take those cold meds. All right.
Oh, can I have them?
No, ooh, I didn't bring those.
Are we
on.
All chilling out?
Oh my god. Oh, did you guys see?
Time
sidebar.
Out.
Yeah.
Oh.
Did you see that news story where those huge sacks of weed washed up on Florida Beach?
Yeah, something like that.
Like drug dealer fucking like
giant pile.
Like 111 pounds or something of just this fucking weed brick. And then it washed up on shore. All the people stood there, looked around, and then a bunch of people just raced over there and started fighting over it. I was like, awesome. Dude, that's crazy. And so now they have all these pictures of these people that were grabbing weed out of the bag and they're just going around arresting them. And I was like, why would you do that?
Oh yeah,
that's so insane. Like California, yeah, good, go for it.
If you really
want
to go down a rabbit hole, look
also,
up.
So the cartel's after you now.
Yeah! Oh my god, I didn't think about that! Oh my god! And there's pictures of you!
Because you're not...
Oh, and they know what beach you were at!
Yeah, you're not robbing from the police. You're robbing from...
I've seen Sicario.
Cuba,
big
man.
Daddy weed, baby.
Yeah, Colombia, not Cuba. What am I saying?
If you really want to go down a rabbit hole, Google, drug-running submarines, because they have gotten to the point where they build their own submarines now.
You know who else does that? Elon Musk. Busted, Elon! Whoa. You're part of the cartel!
Yeah. You. Oh my god.
He smoked weed on stream. I mean, it's pretty obvious. All right, so with that
you
in mind.
You're in the cartel.
Are you my Republican parents?
Don't even get me started. Dude, on politics today. I cannot take
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah. No, okay. Fair.
But seeing that story, I would love to like work in just a little, or maybe it's an unlock in a game or something, where just something, whatever the equivalent of weed is in the D&D universe, just washes up on shore, and the players have to decide what to do with it.
That's
like
awesome.
Fucking moon, a fucking giant thing of moon sugar, just like.
Yeah.
What do you do?
Alton likes to party.
Oh, we know that.
You sort of had that
Jordan
dilemma
is.
In the Sunless Citadel. Remember when you found all the goblins were addicted to that weird like steroid juice or
that's
whatever it was?
That's true.
Oh,
we
yeah.
didn't take it though. It didn't seem fun.
I don't think we drank it. I think
it
we might have taken
fun.
Some, but we didn't drink it. And I think we used it to bribe other goblins.
I guess Jorvin's addicted to mushrooms, but.
Yeah. That's true.
Yeah, he does use them liberally. Although I think with Kyle, he likes his characters to know their way around food.
Yeah, he definitely likes to make cooking characters and stuff like that,
yeah.
Right? Like bakers and cooks.
Is he a cook, or is he just like love Breath of the Wild, or what's going on there?
I think it's one of those things where you can always bring food into whatever situation you find yourselves in. Like,
maybe.
It's the universal kind of like role-playing hook, right?
I mean, Redwall. There was always like every five pages.
Redwall.
Like, the most intoxicating
yes.
face you've ever seen in your life.
I always. Which animal did you want to be in Redwall?
Oh, just a badass badger lady.
A badger
time.
Lady. Mm-hmm. I wanted to be the hare. Because the hare is just jovial and eats so much. But it never made any sense to me because hares are just skinnier than everybody, but they put away more food than even
well,
the badgers.
Well, it's the metabolism. It's because they're
oh,
just always running around
okay, that
and
makes
like,
sense.
Yeah.
All right, so with that in mind,
that looks like chocolate.
It did look like a fun mixed bag.
Yeah, that's how it was like.
Is that from Europe? Are those little chess pieces made of chocolate?
Nothing like some epoxy resin.
Oh, it was a vagina.
Oh,
no.
Oh, Tom brought his fleshlight.
For you to do that, Tom.
First of all,
how do you open these?
It's a cloaca, okay?
Okay, that's not what they're called.
No, that's not, you know.
Oh, I'm not telling you right.
You're not.
Amy.
No, I can do it.
It's fine if you don't want to use a fleshlight. You have nothing to put in there.
I don't know. A penis, Tom? It's a butane-er.
Is that what I'm supposed to
put? It's
a
spill-proof container.
What are you putting in there? Your butt cheek? What are you doing?
Tom.
This is like a fun puzzle.
It's not that difficult of a puzzle, but here we are. Here we are. Have you ever rolled three consecutive ones?
That's actually the only burn you've ever had on this channel.
Yeah,
Tom.
Fuck you.
Last night I rolled three times to throw a rock through a window and failed all of them.
Oh, dude, yeah, I dated a guy who did that.
All right, very good. So you are back here.
He just threw rocks at my window. It was bad at him.
You were running.
That's kind of cute.
No, he's crazy.
You were headed toward the sunken depression that.
Me too.
Yeah. What did you call
me too?
Apparently, the entrance to this.
Wait, do you want me to sing the intro song, Havana? You want to sing the song?
No.
Yeah.
Let's do it. Intro song.
Let's delay.
I don't think we've stalled enough, honestly.
Uh-oh, my bracelet's
I'm starting to think Kyle's not showing up.
We've just been stalling to have him get here, yeah. Wait. I don't have lyrics.
Ooh, today I do.
Wait, did you take mine?
Maybe. Did I?
I don't know.
No. Oh, maybe.
Wait, did you pass it?
Did I pass it?
I thought I saw...
No.
So I said 4-1.
If Amy would just stop writing great songs, I wouldn't have a bunch of these printed out.
Stop writing so many prolific songs.
Nah.
Nah.
Hey, you found it.
Just to reset the scene, you were headed toward the sunken depression of wood here. That is the location of the cursed library of the Green Treaders. There were a number of old, hollowed-out tree trunks that were apparently forest dwellings for those who resided around the library as you were... head in that direction. They look long abandoned and empty.
Witless
me! Thanks for them bits!
Thanks for the bits! Thanks for the bits!
So it was the three, I guess, do we have Jorvin?
I can get him.
I mean, we might as well before I murder
him. Did you forget Jorvin?
Well,
he's
not here!
He's not here!
Doesn't mean he's not here, Eric!
I don't know, I'm not a GM!
Eric.
Yeah, you are!
Eric, why don't you give me that big tube of nastiness? There we go. Perfect.
Your other fleshlight?
Let me try to open this one.
Why did you bring both of them?
Oh, this one
was easy.
One's
the stealth and one's
the... No, one has just a different pattern inside.
Well, what's the inside
One of them looks like a dragon. What?
You know, my sister brought home a goblet.
I'm ready for this.
None of this conversation is going to end up going well.
It had the engraving of the One Ring around it, and I got mad at her because it's black speech. Why would you have that You know what I mean? Like, you're drinking a goblet.
It's like you want to be cursed.
Yeah,
not ideal.
Like, it's like a cool artifact. It's just on the wrong side.
Yeah. How'd it get inside out like that?
Also, it only shows up when you're... Is her goblet always on fire?
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Though, what if it only showed up if you put, like, hot stuff in it? That'd be cool.
Like,
put some hot cocoa in it, and then the texture... That would be kind of cool. Yeah.
I want to wrap it in an envelope and throw it in the fire.
Do it. I say burn anything you don't like.
I know. And that's why I like you. Is that a centaur?
I mean, he's drunk.
There's all kinds of stuff in here.
They're all leaning real hard, man. They're drunk.
Yeah, that one is doing a magic trick. Knees don't work like that.
Yeah, all right. That's okay. These people can go away, probably.
How dare you?
How dare.
Rude.
Rude. Come back.
How rude.
He didn't mean it.
Oh, that is a secret.
How rude.
Uh-oh, she's at it again.
All right. Very good. So, yes, these shambling these rock formations that were embedded in the earth.
Is she hitting on you with diamonds?
I don't know. I can't.
I'm gonna cut your penis off and take it to my house.
Is that sex? I don't know.
Cut it off. Your penis. Take it.
That's it.
She just wants
to take it. Get your penis off and take it.
I mean, I'm not using it.
Full house is dirty.
Did I go pee?
Where's Jorvin, by the way?
I thought you just got him. He's in the box. He's in the little box.
In here?
Yeah.
Look at that.
The pea-colored one.
How cute. All right.
Amy, why do you want to do that to her?
No.
Okay.
Amy, please don't cut off my dick and take it with you.
I don't even know where to start with.
Say it in Japanese.
Oh.
Okay, I'm going to have to Google that.
How do you say please in Japanese? I know how to say that in German.
Is it?
I know how to say thank you.
Bitte. Bitte is please. Bitte.
Bitte.
It's been like 15 years. Okay, I'm getting off my back.
All right.
15 years. How old are you? 20?
Yeah.
Sure. All right. Well, this isn't the greatest representation of Zariestra. Wow, that's not appropriate at
all. And hello to you. Here, use her.
I can't use her. All right, I'm just gonna use this little counter.
On my journey.
So, with that in mind, you've heard a number of sounds around you that kind of sound an awful lot like elves getting murked in the darkness around you, and Alton turned tail as Lowstorm was running towards him, and suddenly these four
technically I wasn't running towards him.
Yeah, you said you were like, I'm gonna book it towards him as soon
no,
as
no, no, I'm gonna book it towards
Oh, out into the forest?
The lady. No, definitely trying to get the group together, but I actually was trying to get everyone to group towards Valiestra, right?
Zariestra. And okay. Hello to you?
Yeah. She told everyone to gather. She's with you.
Yeah.
And I was like...
Yes, but I'm not...
They're out there.
I wasn't... I'm calling him to me. I'm not booking it towards him.
Okay. All right. Fair enough. And you draw your... You're welcome to have a stale French fry.
Don't act like we're not beneath that.
Fair enough. Let's roll for initiative, everyone.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
Wait, so do we see the statues too?
Yeah, of course.
Four statues covered in moss.
Rise up out of the ground.
Oh, they did? They rose up?
And they assemble themselves into these enormous creatures.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I did great. I did great. Kind of.
Mm-hmm. Amy, did you do great?
Yeah. We have these saving throw dice now. They're fucking cool.
What do you mean? I didn't get any. Mm-hmm. Why didn't I get any?
Yeah, how come?
Yeah, dumb.
I got it when I was here for a character building session. Oh, you're about to get some.
I don't even want them.
It's like, it sounds stupid. I don't even...
Yeah, why would that be fun?
It's cool.
Dice! Get your dice!
On my journey to my hanky.
Okay, I rolled a...
Wow, what the fuck?
Oh, that's kind of cool.
It's still going.
Spin, 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 spin. It's still going. It looks like a 5.
It's a 5.
Yeah.
Nice one.
I like those. I like those
stuff thrown at me.
Dang it, Dom! Are you mad? You want to talk about something?
You mad?
You
want to
sit down and talk about something? My God, Jesus! You want to talk about something? You got something on your brain, Dom? Dominic. Dominic. Theodore Zucker.
Zucker.
Zuckerberg. Thanks for setting
I
up.
I know that you're Mark Zuckerberg's nephew.
With a different last name?
Yeah.
Zucker.
No, it's the same last name. He just changed it when he immigrated here.
Yeah.
Darn. Right.
20 and above. Anyone? Anyone?
He came from Planet Sega Genesis.
Oh my God.
I did. No.
16.
Me too. Stop.
Are we like lame?
Are we what?
This lame. This lame.
This lame?
The same.
The same.
This lame.
We are this lame.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
We are this lame.
Oh,
I'm so glad.
Oh, boy.
But you have a higher dex than me, for sure. I have 11 dex.
Thank you for noticing.
All right, so 16 is the highest?
No, 17.
17.
Well, why didn't you jump the fuck in?
Because he hadn't gotten there yet. He said 20 and above. I was waiting my turn.
This is getting treacherous.
Storm.
I think we're all gonna get in a fight.
I hope so.
Monsters.
Physical one.
I'm ready to wrestle.
We haven't had a long rest since we lasted like
negative
spells and stuff. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, but we
did we level though?
We didn't really spend spell. Oh no, we did fight. Yeah, did we level up?
I think we leveled.
Did not.
Actually, Jake did say we were level 8 now.
Cool.
So clocking that.
All right. So, on initiative count 20, there's an enormous wave of necromantic energy. Give me a DC 30, a constitution save, or you lose 4 levels.
Fuck. No. No, wait.
I got a crit! I critted it!
Me too.
So the con is 20.
Okay. Well, you're now level 4.
Oh, great. Critted that. Nice.
I keep rolling 3s, you bitch. Oh, a 1.
All right.
Fucking a 4. On a fucking treadmill.
Treadmill? I feel like you almost said my titular catchphrase.
What is
cat
it?
Phrase. What my is it? Titular catphrase, dick on a cracker.
Dick on a cracker? Oh, I need to start saying that.
It's way better than dick on a treadmill.
What? Yeah.
I don't know why.
So, Alton, it's your initiative tick. You made a terrible perception check. But to look around ahead of you to see what was going on. As
remember?
You turned around, it became very obvious what was happening as these statues rise out of the ground. You do manage to notice one other thing. In addition to, this doesn't, I'm sure, show up on camera very well on our overhead cam, but in addition to the various broken down tree dwellings that are located around the...
Like, right, where am I seeing it? Is it right there? Or is it right there?
Dom, you did a finger. What are you doing? Dom, you mad, bro?
Look at this.
Place these. I think, like,
where's
right here is a good spot.
Love
it.
Oh my God.
Stop.
Oh,
thank you.
That's good. That's good.
That looks way better.
Yeah.
Magic.
I don't think this is on camera.
I think I'm having a heart attack.
Adjust this. I don't think it's on camera.
Eric, you broke Havana. She already was broken, which is... So this is redundant.
I'm fixed now.
Oh, no.
They cancel each other out.
Oh, you... Two breaks make a fix.
Oh, it's very hot in here. I'm having a hot flash, I think.
Yeah. Right. Oh my God, that dog is so lazy. It was not gonna get
super lazy.
It was like 4 inches.
The other thing that you notice though, they're so overgrown with moss that they almost blend into the forest. In fact, when you initially approached this area, you assumed that they were also decayed tree trunks. Mm-hmm. But as you look closer, you can see that these are actually, you can make out the vague shape of They have a vague, almost like a pillar type of shape, right?
We get it. You're better.
And you suspect that You can just see the vague outlines of some carvings in the surface of it, but it's extraordinarily thick with moss.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. But it strikes you as unusual.
And they've risen out of the ground. That's what's risen out of the ground.
No. But there's a number of these, like these ones that are on the map. There's one here. There's one here. There's one here, and there's one here. Right. Those are still standing, projecting up. Like they're tall enough that you can kind of, it's easy to mistake them for trees.
But it's just
trees.
Pillars.
They're four sided. Like they're square pillars that taper up to a gradual point. Right.
Okay.
So they're
very large.
Do we see them too? Or just
yeah, you see them too.
Okay. So they're monoliths.
Mm-hmm.
Good work.
There's a number of them.
Are
also
they obelisks?
Yeah, obelisk is also a great name for them. Give me an axe. Thanks for 7 up.
Thanks, give me an axe.
There's a number of them that are also broken around here on the ground, and that's what these statues have kind of assembled themselves.
Broken like you.
Oh.
Right. It's fine when she says it, Amy.
And that's what these statues have sort of like risen up from, right? These chunks that are laying on the forest floor here. All right. So also while we're
is it a puzzle? Oh, I hope it's a puzzle. Is it a puzzle?
At a break. Apples Within gives a reroll to Eric.
Yay! Thank you, Apples Within.
Thank you, Apples.
Robert the Patriot gives their reroll to Havana Mahoney.
Yay, Robert the Patriot!
And I'm sure that Give Me an Axe gives me a reroll, so I'll just go ahead and
take
that.
I don't think so. Nah, brah.
Alton, it is your action. Let us, now that it is 10-9, kick off this combat.
Okay, I'm going to do what I tried to do a week ago, and I'm going to shoot one of these statues.
Okay.
Zelda style.
Well, bing bang.
A boom. Zelda style.
Natural 20. So.
What happened? What
I'm
is happening?
I'm just going to push through and play again, okay. And okay. We're going to just see what happens.
Okay.
So
why?
Damage.
So nat 20, 14 damage. All right.
Pluto!
Oh my gosh.
Very good.
You did 14 damage to that statue?
Which one are you shooting?
We'll go with the one on Alton's right.
This one? Okay.
Do they actually look like that? Like orcs?
Yeah, do they look like an orc?
Or a skeletal warrior?
So,
of the Roman era?
Of the very specific feathered helm Roman era?
Wow. Wow.
They don't look... They look like a crudely sculpted version of an orc and of a skeleton. So they do actually look somewhat like this, right? Mm-hmm. But they have sort of these rough, angular features as if they were carved from stone by somebody who was... in a hurry and or not very skilled. Give me an X! Give me a reroll! Thank you very much, Jesse. Much appreciated!
Oh, you called it!
Come
you?
For it! Hey.
What's happening right now? Is it an inside joke with you and Give Me an X?
Why did you call Give Me an X, Jesse?
That's Give Me an X's real name.
You guys?
We used to play Adventures League together. That's right. Jesse sat at my table when I ran Storm King's Thunder.
It was an inside joke.
I hope
knowing somebody's
not.
Real name does not make it an inside
no,
joke.
No, I meant that weird
but it gives
thing.
You power.
Yeah, you
no,
did
we
do
never,
a weird
I never
thing.
Did that at the game table.
Why'd you do it? Because it's crazy and we're all feeling a little crazy tonight. Is that the right reason?
Is it maybe because Pluto's
in retrograde?
Pluto's not even a planet.
No, it doesn't have to be in retrograde.
So how's the statue looking?
All right, so you fire an
why
arrow
do you
at this thing.
Why you want to play D&D? Why?
Listen, I brought a Cosmo. Here. Let's just flip through it and see what happens.
Yeah. A Cosmopolitan magazine?
Let's take the test.
You did?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's do
oh
it.
Oh my god, yes, let's take personality tests.
Yes.
You're all bitches.
I know.
I didn't need a magazine to tell me that.
Okay, I'll tell you.
All right.
Are you ready,
it takes damage. It definitely, like, your arrow hits and...
Damn well about it to be. It was the best arrow you've ever seen shot.
One thing I'm that really you notice about weapons. these arrows, you were using one of the elves, one of the Green Trader's arrows.
Yeah.
They're not tipped with metal or wood. They're tipped with some sort of crystal that, as is indicated last week, like when you draw it in the bow, the crystal starts to glow, right? So it hits and does 20 points of damage.
Wait, so that's you have crystalled arrows?
I mean, we dress me up as one of them.
You're right.
I can't believe Tom just gave you that.
Yeah. You're rolling at 20.
All right.
I'm describing what's going on. All right. So that brings us to Strum Thrump. Do you want to move any more? Do you want to move any more than where you are? Noted.
But I can see out and from where I am.
Yeah, I mean, keep in mind that this area of the forest, much like the rest of it, is of the ironwood, is suffused with this weird silvery mist that only lets you see 60 feet, right? So part of the reason that you can only hear these kind of like weird ambush attacks that are apparently happening to the elves around you is you can barely see them. They were 60 feet away, right?
Yeah, the elves.
But you can see, you know, this is 10, 20, 30, 40. So if you're here, you can see out to here.
Okay. And when he hit the statue, did it react or did like
a yeah, it kind just of, fall? Like it slams into the shoulder of the
It made a noise.
Yeah.
Does its face change too? Mm-hmm. Like his mouth can open and like he looks animated?
Yeah.
Or mm-hmm. she? Yeah.
Yep. And in fact, when, you know, as was described, like its hands are kind of like have this like slimy gray ooze kind of dripping off of it. When it, you know, takes a shock like that and goes, argh! You can see that there's like this ooze comes out of its mouth like a big long puddle of drool like down the
is
side.
Is this the ooze we recognize from the other characters or from the people that we remember the two people we fought? The oozes that came
No, those were white luminous oozes, weren't they?
Yeah, those are different.
Or are you talking about in the clearing with the dead?
Yeah, those were black and this is gray.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah. Yeah, well, that's what I mean.
It may be related.
Okay.
It may be related. I don't know. Depends upon how you want to investigate that further. Upon initial glance, you just see that it's some sort of disgusting viscous fluid that drips forth from its mouth as it barks in shock and pain.
Cute. Good point. Mm-hmm. Oh.
Oh. Strumthrum, it is your turn.
Are you just petting them?
No, I'm definitely pointing to them with aggression and import. A little bit of purpose. And with a side of...
They still look like they're made of stone, right?
Yes, they do.
Okay, then I'm going to step forward and cast Shatter.
Yes!
And they look like they're within 10 feet of each other. So
The
one Alton already hit, I'm going to center it between the two of them and All try right. to hit both of them.
Noted. Yay. Very DC, good.
Or the save's going to be 14, and it's going to be a... Oh, you know what? A creature made of inorganic material, such as stone, crystal, or metal, has disadvantage on the saving throw.
Okay. And what kind of save is it?
Constitution.
Mm-hmm. And the DC is?
14.
14.
I think.
Probably.
Yar.
Let's start by rolling some dice, shall we? So this is the one that's been wounded. At disadvantage... I got a 10. Uh-huh. Okay.
So, and I call this, it's called Shatter, but I call it Power Cord.
Power Cord! And then the other one, a disadvantage, gets a 12. I'm not going to reroll this right now. Roll your damage.
Oh, God. I never hit. 3d8. 3d8. I have exactly that.
You have three of those? Nice.
I can never tell what these little ones are. It's this one.
Yep.
They're so cute.
So tiny.
Ooh, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then would I add anything to that?
I don't think so.
Okay. 10 points of damage.
They're just at disadvantage.
They're disadvantage. It doesn't take like double damage or anything. Okay. Take that. Can I reroll damage?
Not with a reroll, no.
What do I reroll?
I don't think we have any unlocks that would let you reroll damage okay. at this point.
That
reroll d20 rolls.
The best.
All right. Very good. Would you like to move at all or take any other type of action on your turn?
Yeah, I think I could do that from where I'm standing.
Yep, definitely.
So could I move over to this pillar?
Over here?
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. And then could I cast Prestidigitation as a bonus action and clean off the face of one of the pillars to try and see if there's anything notable on it?
Normally I would say no, but since you're functionally doing the same thing as just using your hands to like peel moss off, I think it's reasonable in this circumstance.
Oh, you're saying normally prestidigitation is in a bonus action?
It's an action.
Well, normally you can't.
It can't. Oh.
Normally.
Oh, it is one action.
You,
it is.
You can't do two spells, but.
Well, yeah. I guess I could just do it with my hands. Then that's fine too.
You can use the spell. I'm not going to be a stickler about it in this particular circumstance. As long as you understand what the.
I mean, that's legit. I thought it was a bonus action for some reason.
Okay, so you look at this thing. Gum.
Quam Cremant.
And a good day to you.
Isn't that what it's called?
All right.
Quim or not.
Do you speak any Elvish?
No, but I have my notebook. I could write it.
Why don't you give me an Intelligence Arcana check, please?
Oh, and I have history, too.
We need Kyle for Arcana.
I'm proficient in Arcana.
Oh, okay.
Perfect.
We don't need Kyle for anything.
I'm proficient in Arcana.
That's a joke.
Trouble in Paradise?
Let me tell Kyle.
I'm going to text him right now.
He's probably watching.
Ooh,
he
said he was 18. Gonna... Mm-hmm. So that's going to be +5, so 23.
Okay.
I learn Elvish instantly.
So you can tell that that this
obelisk... I've been teaching
obelisk...
swears in Elvish.
I imagine you have been, actually.
You can tell that this obelisk, even though it's been sort of covered with the suffocating moss of the forest and years, if not centuries, of neglect, is for some reason beginning to thrum with magical power.
You said thrum.
It may! You don't know if it was the act of you cleaning it off mm-hmm. that caused this to well up. You don't know if it was beginning to charge up and you just happened to like remove the moss so that you could see that it was happening or whatever it was. But you can tell that something is beginning to, some sort of eldritch energy is beginning to well up within this obelisk. There's a variety of runes that kind of like go up and down the edges, the periphery of each edge of the obelisk. They're, because you don't speak Elvish and because you're still learning,
I also am a proficient in history. I don't know if that would, if there were, maybe I don't understand the language, but maybe there's specific symbols that would make sense to me just from like knowing bardic lore.
That's the whole thing, right?
Oh, okay.
There's most of it that you don't understand, right? But there's a pattern of symbols that you recognize from your arcane studies that are clearly related to a poison and cloud.
Okay, I don't think I can write anything down this round because I've used up all my shit, but I might next time.
You get the distinct impression that if you were to trace those runes, you might be able to unleash that effect somehow.
But what inside me says that?
You because you study magic, right?
Intuition.
Yeah, your bardic intuition and
you just gotta find the button.
Oh, because I've played a lot of Skyrim. Okay, okay. Yeah. Poison and cloud.
I unlocked I picked a lock using Skyrim methods, like a real lock.
I'm not sure. You should say that on stream.
It was a lie. It was
I did a crime.
It was to my apartment. I locked myself out.
You also stole that marijuana off the beach. Yeah. Secrets out.
Guys.
Wow.
The
Are you
dirty
part of the
blonde...
cartel?
No.
Wow.
See.
Okay.
So, and I'm sorry. When you say, I get the impression, if I trace them, I could use it. Is that like fucking... Yu-Gi-Oh style, or is that like something I'd have to say out loud?
You would let me put it this way. You would have to use
Naruto?
Use an action.
Naruto?
Use an action to tap into and activate the power of the obelisk.
Well, it's like, yeah, in Japanese culture, they would have their spells would be like written out and they would like throw it.
Throw the actual spell.
Yeah, the paper. Yeah.
This would be more like you would have to like touch the obelisk and do some sort of either gesture or invocation, and then the power would be unleashed through the obelisk, right?
Oh, it would just go everywhere.
I don't. Who knows?
Sounds like
like something.
That's kind of TBD.
TBD, but
I'm like resistant.
You feel like you would have some sort of like because you're invoking it, you'd be able to channel
some sort
it somehow.
Of control. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
But
you know, it's certainly magic that's beyond your normal
right
capabilities.
Okay, but I can't do that this round.
Correct.
Right.
You've ascertained that you would be able to do that next round if you used your action to attempt this. All right, that's Strum. Low Storm.
Oh, I'm going to do something I've never done before.
Oh, no!
So I am going to run into the middle of these two gray statues, and I'm going to kind of slide, if you imagine, like, baseball, you know, baseball? Imagine a slide on baseball.
Baseball.
I'll end up on one knee with my spear in hand, and I'll slam down with the spear, and then my hand will also touch the earth. And as I do, I cast Earth Tremor. And these two guys have to make a dex saving throw of 14.
Uh-huh. Dex saving throws.
Yeah, because
huh?
I'm tremoring the earth.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Oh, is this going to be the big one?
No, this isn't the big one. I just have never done this before and I wanted to. And I want to make some statues topple.
Okay. DC 14, huh?
DC 14.
Are they
just
are
these
they
two guys?
Just those two. It's only 10 foot radius.
So the red one is the one on the left. One makes it, one fails. This guy fails.
Okay, he is prone and takes 9 points of damage.
Mm-hmm.
And the other guy, nothing really happens. He just felt an earth tremor.
Dude, if he's a statue, can he even fucking get up?
Yeah, he's prone. Also, all of his limbs fall off. It says it. I don't know. It says it.
All his limbs. What a weird addition.
Correct.
If they happen to be a statue.
No. All right.
No, there's no caveat for statue. It's just anyone affected, their lips fall. Statue
just
or no.
Pop. Oh,
yeah.
Gosh.
Can you pass me a pencil, please?
Is there anything else you would like to do then? So you slide in, slam
is
your...
Is there enough?
Boom. You knock this...
Is that your final answer?
Foul creature prone to the ground.
Yeah, I do.
And
I'm gonna pee on his face.
And that is that.
My pee and poop are the same.
Yeah,
so
you don't.
It's really
it's
gonna
one
be
thing.
Really gonna so, be a
yeah.
mess.
All right.
Oh.
So
really fun. No, the Spirit of Justicia is like super OP and broken. Oh, but I can't use it again, can I?
I believe you already used it today. Am I wrong?
No, you're right. I think I used it against.
We haven't had a long rest since last time.
We had a short rest.
Yeah,
you
technically.
Use it against the creatures in the clearing. Mm-hmm.
On the thing, it does not say how many times a day I can use it. On your paper that you gave me. There's no limitation, in fact.
Just whenever.
I think I've read it and reread it and been like, this seems real.
How could I
explain
this?
All right. But well,
yeah,
these two guys close in on Alton.
Bring it. I'm wearing leather.
Okay. Very good. This guy stands up.
Nuh-uh. He's a statue. How'd he do that?
It's so weird.
How did he do that?
Yeah, there's no limit. Limited. But I feel like it's broken and I want to do other things. Thanks, RJ Canuck!
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
How did he stand up? Explain it.
Pick two numbers between 1 and 6.
Wait, don't I get an opportunity attack if he stands up?
No.
Yeah.
No, that's
only
3-5. Pick two numbers between 1 and 6.
1 and 6.
Well, this is a good story.
4
uh-huh.
and 2.
Okay.
Let me thwack him.
I rolled a 3. He does not come after you. All right. So,
I thought I lost, but really I won.
These two guys flank you, and let's begin. So.
She's excited.
All right. So.
Hit me, baby, one more time.
They each slam at you with their massive. Well,
good luck,
because
I've got an armor class of 12.
Armor class 12. Look out!
Always forget right. You're a fucking druid.
I'm gonna reroll that natural one.
No, you can't reroll ones.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
We used to have a rule where you can reroll ones. What happened to us?
So 13 plus 5 is 18.
What happened to
that
us?
Hits you.
Yes, it does. Mm-hmm. Yes, it does. Come at me.
All right. How about 9 points of damage?
How about that?
Did we even take like a short rest after that?
You took a short rest.
Yeah,
yes.
Short.
Okay, then. 9 points, you said? Yeah, then I'm going to use my Stone's Endurance and not take that. Or try not to. Yeah, I definitely do not take any of that damage.
It still hits you, though, yes?
It does hit, yeah.
Okay,
but
great.
I reduce the damage dealt to me by 1d12 plus 2, so I reduce it by 14.
Wow!
I rolled a 12.
Great. So you take no damage. However, you are slimed by the odorous ooze that is dripping off of this thing, and you can see that it's like, again, running out of the crook of its mouth, and the slime stings your flesh. Give me a DC 13 constitution save, please.
With pleasure.
Oh
dick. I got wait, what is, have any of us been, have any of us been conned yet? Should I reroll this or save it?
How many rerolls do you have? I have a bunch. I have like 6.
I might. I don't like. I don't like that roll. It was not good.
Okay.
Oh yes, I make it then. Okay. Oh, I don't. Fuck. Mm. How high?
13.
Yeah, I don't make it. Okay.
What's your con modifier?
Plus 2.
Mm-hmm. Oh. That's pretty good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I rolled a 10.
Okay.
Do you want another reroll? You can have one.
No, I want to see what happens here.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah. Look.
The first time an enemy hits you, and then you were. Have to make a saving throw.
Oh, I'm sorry. Good. It's a DC 12. What did you?
12.
You did get a 12?
Oh.
All right.
Tom tried to cheat.
Mm. Hey, Tom. I'm going to remember this.
Amy wants we'll to fail this.
So your Goliath skin, you feel it begin to kind of like harden and fracture under the like the sting of this ooze, right? Like you can feel your skin actually like become kind of like leathery tough. But you manage to like quick swipe it off and it drips off before it begins to fully set in and take effect. But there's your arm is numb and you can tell that like the skin is discolored. It's like patchy gray.
What about my tattoos?
They're temporarily kind of like fogged over by this thing.
But I have like really awesome tattoos.
Maybe you should roll better.
They're temporarily fogged over?
Yeah, so it's like, it's almost as if like imagine somebody like sprayed like a white kind of, like, you know, remember that like, that burn spray that you used to get, like if you get really bad sunburn, like solar cane or whatever, you'd spray it on and you'd have like a white patch on your skin.
Oh wow!
It's like that.
Okay.
You have kind of this misty, the gray fog kind of discoloration to your skin.
Guys, I'm not a tank. Mm-hmm. I'm not a tank.
Yeah. So that's not good.
You shouldn't move out of the area after you hit them like you were.
I wanted them to fall over.
Alton.
Yep.
I mean, you had a movement after you dealt with them. You could have gotten away from them.
That would have been attack of opportunity.
Not that guy who was
prone. They were both with 10 feet away, I think.
Oh, that's right. Well,
all right.
Fuck it, man.
So one of them takes a swipe at you.
Go for it.
Armor class 15?
Miss.
That's a miss. All right.
The other one takes
its weird kind of like slimy hands and slams them together, right? And you see a spark of almost like sheer white light flash off of its hands, and the gray ooze turns to like a silvery silver color, right? And it drips over its face and down its chest, and you see its body take on this metallic sheen. And there's
a
momentary hum. And give me a strength saving throw, DC 15, please.
Okay. What is happening here?
I can do this, because despite being a fighter,
strength is not your thing.
No, it's in fact tied for my worst stat.
Weird.
Yeah. So And also, we'll probably give you one of these. just for funsies. Sure. Just for funsies.
15 is what you're looking for.
Yeah.
And then we're going to be level 5.
Ooh,
yeah,
nice.
Yeah, I'll take that 17.
17, all right.
Or 19 total.
Level 3 DM RJ Canuck sends a reroll to Eric and Havana.
Yay!
So you can have that right back.
Level 3!
All right, so as this pulse of energy flows through the body of this thing, right? You can sense everything that you are wearing that's metallic kind of like suddenly shift, and your rapier that you have on your hip.
That's probably the only thing metallic on me right now.
Yeah, it slides up out of its sheath, and you like grab it in kind of like midair and slam it back. Or whatever you want to do with it. Like, if you want to drop your bow and draw your rapier, like, I'll let you do that for free.
Yeah, I think if they're within, I can't fire a bow at this range, so I'd probably grab it and I'm ready to go.
Yeah, and but it slides out and you're like, whoa, and you grab onto it, and then you kind of like pull it around and point it at them. That is all.
I did something cooler. It came out, I grabbed it, and then I spin it around. Like, it spins around my hand and then I catch it, so it's right.
Yeah, like
up.
Tom Cruise in Cocktail.
Yeah. I was thinking the Winter Soldier, but cool, yeah.
Tom Cruise in Cocktail.
Yeah. You know, that's where I learned the word aglet.
Yeah.
I haven't actually watched it because I have dreams and ambitions.
All right.
I learned it from Phineas and Ferb. They did a song about the aglet.
Phineas and Ferb, why are you watching
Phineas that? What?
Phineas and Ferb. It's a great cartoon.
Definitely you were too old when that came out to be watching that.
It's a really good cartoon.
Kyle would probably back you up. He loves all cartoons.
I love cartoons, but Phineas and Ferb is like, isn't it specifically for like toddlers?
No.
No?
No.
Oh, okay. What about Blue's Clues?
That's for toddlers.
Oh.
Suddenly there is...
I love babysitting.
Suddenly there is a shadowy female form who appears right next to Zariestra.
And hello you.
And
she's
Alton.
Is she that tall? Yes. Yes. Zariestra. Hello. Alton.
And she has
Steve Rogers.
It's hard to tell exactly what sort of weapon it is, but she has some sort of very small curved knife. Perhaps, or dagger in her hand, and she makes two quick cuts at Zariestra. And Zariestra
that is some
ticks.
Snake shit. Uh-uh. Mm-mm.
Yeah, I'm gonna get her.
Cut it out. Ma'am?
Take 16 points of damage.
Zariestra!
And hello to you.
Is she gonna attack?
And that's something that it's got in one
thank
hand,
you,
right?
Weasel, PhD for whatever you did, I can't see it. So they covered up that part of the screen. Awesome.
They don't want us to know.
No, they subbed.
Well, we can't
you
see
can
that.
You can see. Yeah, must can. Be nice on that side of the table.
Yeah. Ah, feels good.
All by yourself, you can man spread. And you can read the screen.
And Jorvan kind of turns and looks, and he's like, "What?" You know. And she holds something up, and you're not sure what she's got in her hand.
This it's a lantern.
All happening very,
it's a small
very
bear.
Quickly, right?
groceries. It's a badger.
And
it's a demon. It's a demon.
I tell you what, you guys are really engaged in what's going on, but I'll let you each make perception checks to see if you can figure out what she's got.
I choose to fail. I'm in the middle of a very important fight right now.
Fair enough.
I'm not doing anything.
13.
Mm-hmm.
I've got a 15 plus. Like eight.
You can't tell because you got your back to this whole scenario.
Fine.
Right? But you can see that it looks like maybe she has some sort of small tome or book in her hand.
Thank you,
John. And
small tome.
And she says something, and you see kind of this spiraling vortex of spirits, like spectral, haunting, stretched out ghosts, encircle Jorvan, and he begins to kind of like.
Oh, this is Luigi's Mansion shit?
Like, every time someone can't be here, their soul is ripped from their body.
that doesn't
Tom
happen.
Tom never got over the Lantern of Nidox.
Yeah, that's right.
You know when you weren't here, we didn't things. Make up like a Tom Lomo character and suck his soul out.
You know what? Next week is your chance to shine.
No, Jay has to make this
What's
character.
Next week.
Jay's I'll be gone here. Next week.
Oh, Canada.
He's going to Canada.
Canada. All right, so that is all of the monster's turn. Zariestra, it is now her turn. She turns around and you can tell that she can't tell where this thing is coming from.
Oh, and hello to you.
Thank you.
And she draws her bow, and you see her elvish ears kind of like twitching, trying to figure out like what attacked her, where did that come from, what happened, and she actually turns to Jorvan and says like where is she, what happened, you know. So she
Jorvan says that to her.
She says that to Jorvan. She's like, I don't see anything.
She can't see the ghosts.
She doesn't see this person right here.
Person who just stabbed
Zariestra, you
girl,
open your eyes. Get your head out of your drawers.
She's firing basically a disadvantage. So a 7 plus 7 is 14.
Is that the waste lady?
I think it's the waste lady.
Did you just nod at me?
It's fairly clear though. This is
But is she like hot or what?
Yeah.
What's her butt? Roll for butt.
Butt roll. 2d6 for butt roll.
Do you know Jay made each die a cheek?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So.
No, she's horrifically emaciated.
No butt.
You look at her, no booty. And you see.
She's got bird bones.
Almost a mummified elven woman, right? Like blackened skin stretched tight over thin elven bones. Two hollowed eyes that are covered by a thin pus-stained strip of gauze.
Is this like inspiration of the nurses from Resident Evil?
Yuck.
Silent Hill.
Thank you.
The only video game I play is Yu-Gi-Oh!
Jokes on you. Not a video game.
No,
it's a fucking card game originally. And
there's a lot of
then it was a show.
Stuff.
I know, but that's not like its fucking thing.
Right. I think he was kidding.
I apologize.
I know, but that's why I'm calling him on his shit, because he's telling lies.
The only video game I play is Pitfall, Air Raid, and Space Invaders.
What year is it, Tom? I don't think you know what year it is, Tom.
Thank you to Pickle Weasel PhD for sending me a reroll.
Oh, Pickle Weasel, you've really made mistakes.
So Zariestra fires off one of her crystal bolts, arrows.
Thanks, Blip.
Just wildly Thanks, off into the woods, completely misses, and to you, Strum, you're like, the woman is right there. Right? She's like it would be like firing an arrow, you know.
Oh, due to my height?
Point blank.
Oh, it's
and
on that
she
beach
points weed. In the wrong direction and just like lets one loose into the woods and it's gone.
I go, Zariestra!
Hello. And hello to you. And hello to you.
Zariestra.
Zariestra yourself.
All right.
Zariestra at you.
Jorvan
and
is
Zariestra upon your family.
Encased in this necrotic miasma, and begins to kind of like you see his bones kind of light up in from inside of him as one of the spirits goes in.
Is that your Jorvan?
He inhales one.
My bones.
And his limbs
They're
begin
hollow.
To freeze up, and he's like,
Oh no! My God. Oh, we have so many things to deal with. And Zariester's a fucking idiot and she's shooting it blind.
He only takes 6 points of damage at this point.
Oh my God, you weren't kidding. You're gonna kill him.
Yeah, it's not fair, Tom.
I know.
You need to like think through this. Think through this. Is this what you want to do? Is this really how you want this to go? Play it all the way through. Because I can guarantee you it's not gonna end how you think it will.
Tough talk for somebody who's surrounded by two statues. All right.
No, this is
flanked.
Out, this
called
is out of game now. Just go through every possibility of what could happen if you kill Jorvan tonight. To your wife.
What could happen to my wife?
Well, Amy could come and steal her away, seduce her.
All right.
Lindsay wants me.
You almost said something weird.
She did say something weird, as a matter of fact.
I mean, it was going to be weirder. She dialed a man.
Yeah. It's not like I I don't. It's not like I don't have.
As long as I have my butaner, I'm okay.
I just have a small filter.
Jervin strikes with his claws at the weird lady next to him. A 4 and a 2.
Oh my god!
Miss.
Oh my god!
Well, I
oh my
give Jervin a reroll.
Yeah. You can't roll a 2 and a 4 on Jorvin's turn.
That's not fair. Let us roll it. Let me roll it. I want to roll it.
A 2 and a 4.
He only gets a reroll for one of his attacks, though.
That's bullshit.
That's another 2.
You oh my fucking roll god! It. Why do you get to roll it?
Yeah. Have it roll it, Havana. Tom's cheating.
Let me roll it.
Roll.
Tom's cheating.
What'd
you get?
Natural one!
Jorvin, you're dead!
Alright, okay, one more and then I'm not spending any more on this.
Wow.
This is how they get you into Vegas.
Crit! 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 Crit!
All right. I'm sure Jervin has some bullshit thing where he gets to add like twice the dice. So give me.
We better call. It's Kyle in the chat. 2d6
plus
2d8,
please.
2d6
plus 2d8.
Oh, damn.
Mm-hmm.
No.
He critted.
That'll be pretty good. Thanks so nice. You roll them twice. That's what Sean Graham used to say. I miss Sean Graham.
Me too.
Oh.
He's in a better place.
So, oh my god, that's Colorado. Terrible. Nice 10. 19. Ooh, baby. Ooh, baby.
19 points of damage. And I'm sure he's got probably a plus 3, so we'll just round that off to a nice 22. Very good. 22 points of damage. Question. Some of that damage is probably magical, but the rest of it is
not. Yeah, you gave him those magical badger claws.
The badger claws are not magical.
Oh, I thought you gave him that. We all got a magical item.
He has a magic spoon.
What was on the D6s?
Oh, yeah, he makes
what did you roll for the D6s? Do you remember? The 2D6?
It was a 6 and a 4.
Oh, okay. All
right. Why?
He's got a magic spoon that makes cake.
We're fire resistant for a minute.
Noted. Very good. Yeah. All right, that was Jervin. Yeah, round 2, right. Alton, we're up to you. You've
right.
got
3
your...
minutes. Got my rapier out.
Rapier out.
30
I'm
minutes?
I'm going to stab the an guy hour. That I stabbed, oh. or I shot okay. with an arrow.
3 hours.
A year.
I'm going to. That's probably not going to be enough, right?
Kill it!
Unless it's,
kill it with fire!
Kill it with fire!
Is a 14 enough to hit?
Is a 14 enough to hit? That's a great question. No, they're armor class 16. I'm sorry.
All right, then we're
oh, is it because they're statues?
Oh.
Then how come they can stand up?
I'll take that 18 to
wait,
hit.
What did magic. Making him prone even do? Is that it took his movement away from him?
Yeah.
Fucking, why did I do that?
11 damage.
I just to
at least you didn't grapple him.
11 damage.
Whee!
What a
to
waste.
The one that you hit before.
Yeah, and then I'm going to action
no, it
surge.
Does, it's ooh. A broken mechanic.
Uh-huh. And stab him again. That's going to be a hit. That's 17.
Okay.
I have a PowerPoint, I'll show you.
And that's, let's see, 14 damage for the second hit.
Okay, great. That destroys it. It shatters into...
Hey, you destroyed a statue just like Zelda from the game Link.
Link in the yesteryear.
Link in the shiny bush.
Oh, I didn't play that one.
It's good one.
Very good. Anything else you would like to do? Movement, anything?
No. Zelda to the past.
I'm just like, Zelda, look at this fucking hat.
Strum Thrum.
What?
Did you make a Minish Cap joke? How dare you?
What is Minish Cap?
It's like the most uncelebrated Zelda game.
He's got a hat that's a bird.
It's actually a pretty cute hat.
Strum Thrum, you're standing next to this magical obelisk. You can see this strange mummified elven woman wearing these very regal but tattered silken robes.
Oh, is there anything shiny on her?
Is Brendan Fraser there?
I fucking hope not.
No, Tom
why?
Cruise.
Take it back. Take it back.
Amy, if I'm not interested in him, it means you can have him.
Why don't you like Brendan Fraser?
One thing that you notice that it looks like she has gold thread embroidered into the hem of her her tattered robes.
Love it. Okay, well, I think sort of in a panic.
I love Brendan Fraser.
Good. I'm so happy for you.
Listen, I'm with you. I don't know.
He just has a punchable face, okay?
No.
Yeah, he does.
How can you not love that when he tries to clap and he can't do it right? You ever seen that gif? Brendan Fraser clapping? It's like him at the Oscars trying to clap, but he misses. He goes...
So you get it. You get it that he's punchable.
No, he's adorable. And sexy as hell. He's fine. Yeah, he is.
Well, I don't know what you're into, but you can be attracted to him and want to punch him, I guess.
See, there's regular Brendan Fraser, who's like, meh. But then there's Midnight Brendan Fraser. Meow.
He has brown eyes.
Midnight Brendan Fraser is just the movie Monkey Bone.
Yeah. All right, Monkey Bone, it's your turn. What would you like to do?
Please never call me by my real name ever again.
Don't speak the true name.
Really charming. Really charming. Well, I would like to, kind of in a panic, I've got that feeling that I could kind of control these runes to cast a spell, mm-hmm. and I'm thinking over the consequences of that and what's happened in the past, but then I'm also seeing Jorven getting bamboozled over here, so I think I'm just going to go for it. I'm just going to try to manifest this spell in the runes and target the woman in the robes.
Okay.
The waste lady, as it were.
The waste lady.
Waste lady!
Why don't you give me an arcana check, please, to channel this
magical arcana check.
Energy.
Ooh,
it's an 8.
13? Wait, right? 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, yeah. 13, do it?
What? You release the...
Wait, okay, I want to reroll. I'm scared. I'm real scared.
That's worse.
It's okay, thank you, Tom. Yeah. I just need to use
it. For those of you in chat, she rolled worse that time.
Oh, there we go. Okay, 19 plus 5 is a 24.
All right, very good.
Three year olds, chat.
Yay!
Saving the day like you do, chat.
So, you draw forth a small ball of swirling red mist.
How am I interacting with the runes?
Kind of like touch the runes and you feel their power kind of course down your arm and then begin to like course through your body and you're like, I don't know what to do with this. And so you put your claws out, your hand out, and you see a swirling red, like bubble of red mist begin to form in your hand and kind of like burbling and if you think of like dry ice in a Halloween cauldron.
A remember
right?
all. I have a remember all in my hand.
Yeah, so it's
and I've forgotten something.
It's seething and bubbling. But you can tell that it seems to be growing in pressure. As if like there's more mist getting filled into this bubble, it is like and the bubble is beginning to stretch and burst, and you fling it away from you towards this woman, and you realize that there's so much power in this thing that you need to kind of finesse this beyond just throwing it directly at her, and so you overthrow her by about 15-20 feet, which fortunately turns out to be exactly how big this thing mushrooms into, right? So suddenly it bursts into this noxious cloud that has a 20-foot radius sphere.
Why are you bringing that up? Why is that being brought up right now? What is it relevant? Why is this? Stop it! Why? This isn't relevant to anything. I just have buttons that you like to push.
The weird thing isn't that she sleeps like this, but she like gets up with like as a plank like this, and rises completely. Standing.
Why did you watch Amy wake up?
But
the alarm goes off as soon as it goes off, and goes.
Yeah.
But the cute part about it that you're not mentioning is when I do that, I go wee.
Yeah. It cuts the tension.
And then she boings out of bed.
Yeah.
It goes straight to this to an upward standing boings.
And then the first thing out of her mouth is the Japanese words for I love you.
It's a good way to start the morning. It's a good morning
What
mantra.
Is that? What is it? I won't repeat it. You can do it, right?
It's been a while. I'd have to look it up.
Oh, okay.
So it's
I thought you were speaking.
But you were just mumbling.
You just
go, I have a gazimus.
It's a stinging cloud of reddish mist.
I have a gazimus?
That swirls around.
You said you wouldn't. You said you wouldn't.
I was just saying
repeat
hello
it.
And good morning. How are
Amy,
you?
Stop.
I thought he was saying English. So what the fuck?
She made her saving throw.
No.
Yes, she made her saving throw. But that's half damage. So.
This is some bullshit.
Reroll!
What is this waste lady? Did Jay build waste lady or did you build
Are you
lady?
Rolling the damage for my cloud? What is wrong with you?
Why don't you go ahead and roll 3d8?
I don't understand where you get off, sir.
Yeah.
I know where you get off in your two fleshlights that you bring to the studio. Stop.
Yeah,
14 plus, what is this number? Six. So 20.
Okay.
Yeah, 20 damage. That was way better than your three threes, you monster.
She takes half damage.
Yeah, because she rolled a 20. Because when he rolls for Waste Lady, she gets crits. When he rolls for Jorvin, even though it's four dice, he gets twos and fours.
There's a swirling sphere of this weird poisonous mist that's encircling her right now. All right. Anything else you would like to do? Use your action. Do you want to move at all?
Cry. I'll give my bardic. I don't want to give it to Jorvin because then you're controlled to bardic inspiration.
Give it to Lostar.
You're next.
Mm-hmm.
I'll give my last bardic inspiration to Lostar.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Or what I have said.
Actually, don't give it to me. Give it to him because my spear doesn't need to hit. It just magically does it.
That seems OP.
Yeah, you broke it. You broke the game with this. Look, it just does. There's no two hit on there.
Amy's always right.
Whatever she wants.
You did this. It just there's a nimbus of electricity, and I get to tell it where to go.
Yep. That's true.
But I do. I am letting you say it's once per long rest. I'm letting you have that.
Very good. You are nothing if not a generous DM.
All right. What level GM is Amy?
Amy's like a level 6 GM. Look at her.
Is that good?
I could see that.
She wrote a song about it and did an amazing music video, which exactly. You haven't seen. You have to watch the Dungeon Master's Lament.
Amy, we love you.
Thank
you.
Love you,
Amy.
You don't have to be a great GM to write a song about it, though.
No, but it helps.
Just to be clear.
But you do have to be a good musician to write a good song about it.
Yeah, I'm not going to disagree with you that I'm talented beyond all measure.
All right, so you give Alton your bardic inspiration.
Sure.
Are you moving at all?
Are
you happy with where
you
are?
I might. So I've uncovered one side of this pillar, right?
That's true. Mm-hmm.
But there are four sides.
Mm.
Can I move to the back side of the pillar just to be a little bit out of
over here
range, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then, and I've expended my bonus action.
Yes.
And I've used my action and I've moved. Yeah. So I think I'm done. Yeah.
Fair.
Cool.
All right. That brings us to Lowstorm.
I was going to use my spear, but I forgot I already used it. Oops.
Wait, so I could have given you bardic inspiration?
Yeah.
Well, it's not too late.
In like 2 seconds.
I'll give you back he's on bardic inspiration if you want.
Who needs it?
No, I'll just cast a spell. That's what I'm going to do.
Yes.
Who needs it?
Spell cast
a spell.
I'm
actually going to try to hold person on that humanoid. Is she a humanoid?
That's a D6.
Yeah.
Yeah, what's yours?
Bardic inspiration.
She needs to make a wisdom saving throw.
That's, yeah.
D6 14.
Until,
Yep.
All right.
Six or something.
You need D20.
Mm-hmm. And that's my last second level spell. Oh, God.
Well, let's see. I got an 8.
No, just let me have it.
15 plus 2 is 17.
Yeah, that'll beat my... It. So, that burned it. Yep, that's it. That's all I do. Is there any way... I can't really leave without getting opportunity attacked.
That's true at this point.
Okay, I'll stay put then. I don't want them attacking other people.
Okay.
Well, I tried, guys. You see me just, scrunching at my face and determination and will. Yeah.
And to be honest, I'm kind of busy right now. I don't see that.
I'm not looking at you either.
And my arm reaches out towards the waist lady and
statues.
I go... Worst lady. And nothing happens. Literally nothing happens.
You
I look
just,
crazy.
You just see two green flashes of light as her eyes glitter in your direction.
I haven't done Lostorm's voice yet. Oh,
it's
damn.
True.
Mm-hmm. What the fuck?
Okay.
That is not tribe.
Yay!
Viventar! Raid from Viventar!
Yay, thank you for the raid!
Or is it Vi-Eventar?
Vi-Eventar.
Vi-Eventar.
You're welcome.
Vi-Eventar.
Vi-Eventar.
Bless you.
Zariestra.
And hello to you.
And Vaiventar to you.
Vaiventar.
And also with you.
Zariestra, Vaiventar. Alright.
Amy, do you want to move?
I don't, because I'll get attacked of opportunity.
I thought you guys said they were each 10 feet away from me.
They used to be.
They closed in.
When I tried to prone them, but
yeah.
They didn't like that.
Proned you. Mm-hmm.
All right, so speaking of, like, let's get around to...
Just because you provoke an AoE doesn't mean it hits.
All of this.
I don't have the highest armor class.
Oh, that's right.
I have an armor class of 12.
All right,
my
so...
My dex is zero.
One of them is going to try to slam you again. I think... that an armor class of 20 is probably going to hit you.
Yes.
I think you're going to take... Wow!
Wow!
That's
the most cock shit I've ever seen.
I don't know, I think that's pretty clear.
Wild.
Pretty clearly
I
a fucking
literally
one.
Literally, like, threw it onto an edge. I've never done that.
That is so cool. I'm very proud of you, and I think it's cool.
Scales.
So, 7 plus 3 is 10 points of damage.
Okay.
and I need you to make another
con
save, DC 12.
Con?
No, it didn't make it. I'll re-roll that, though. It's my last re-roll. Guys, I'm gonna die. Oh, yeah, I really didn't make it.
Fucking fuck!
Okay.
Alright, so unless somebody else is going to throw another reroll.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Most
Amy,
arms
you
away.
Do you
want
to
give
you one? No, don't worry about it. Don't worry
I've
about
got
it. Don't
three.
Worry about it. There's not much left. Oh, God. Okay, thank you. Oh, my God. I don't want to die. Where are you? Yeah, I don't think it's happening. It's a 6 plus 2, it's 8.
Here you go.
No, guys!
What is this
okay,
for?
We love you, Amy!
Is this a fart roll?
The great ooze is,
oh, it's
is
a con
falling
save.
Over her.
You wanted to fail save. Earlier. What happened?
It's not that I wanted to fail. I just...
We love you, Amy.
I just can't
fucking
roll.
Amy, we
roll.
Love you.
Thank you. I love you, too. 4?
Wow.
She finally said it.
Oh, I meant Havana.
Oh. Yeah, that's what I knew.
I wish I had some suspenders on.
Yeah, I ate up everyone's rerolls and I still failed. Guys, this
do
is
you need another one
this
to
is
help?
The week I've been having. Yeah, I'll take another one. No, I'm just kidding. Don't do it.
You asked Eric to do something. I'm not sure what you thought was gonna happen.
He wait, hold on. He did it. Oh, please, baby, please. Yes.
Will you?
15.
You made it.
All
right.
Thank you, Eric.
So again, this ooze flows over you, and you really like you feel like your skin is actually maybe turning to some sort of like
it's just a chemical peel
shale, right? You can feel your arms stiffen up and
no,
my
arms are marbled,
and your skin cracks as you try and flex against the numbing effect
the
of this
bleed
ooze.
Crack?
You got a moisturizer.
What'd you call
yeah,
my butt?
That's part of the effect, right? Is like.
Why are you bleeding out your butt? Why do you? Why? Go to the doctor.
It's my bleed crack.
And again, you swipe this stuff off, and it drizzles to the ground before
it's
it can funny. Really seep in and take a. RJ Canuck is in for 10. Thank
RJ
you so
Canuck.
Much.
Thank you, RJ.
Thank you, RJ.
Awesome. So that's on the one side. On the other side, this guy generates. You know, he takes his oozing fists and slams them together over his head, and there's another spark of light, right? And that drizzles down over him, and he thrums with power. What metallic items do you have on your person?
This is Zelda's.
I think spear. I don't.
Yeah. The head
that,
of the spear for sure, right?
That's kind of
whole
it.
Session on
okay,
Zelda's.
So give me a DC 15 strength saving throw, please.
DC 15.
But it's strength.
So I've not been rolling well at all. Mm-hmm. Oh, I did. 22.
22. All right. So the spear kind of like momentarily like points and like gets drawn over towards
like a
this
magnet.
Thing. Yeah, exactly like a magnet. Like, whoa, but you rein it in easily.
Yeah. Oh, that's great because yeah, I don't have many
time
items.
For that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
ain't nobody
got time for that.
Ain't
but
nobody.
Good for you. All right. In the meantime, let's do some damage to Mr. Alton Newberry, shall we?
Take a try.
Miss.
Armor
miss.
Class 12, which miss. Is another miss. And I'm not going to use my final reroll for that, so that's
laughs.
The way that
laughs.
That lays out. Meanwhile, over here, That's not canon.
He laughs like snidely with flesh.
Jervin gets to make an AOO against the wasted lady because she's moving.
Okay, roll for...
I'm hiding.
Roll for attack of
she's
opportunity.
She's coming for you.
Roll for Jorvin, if
I mean,
you'd
she's
like.
Gonna.
Jorvin attacks.
Or I can roll for
no,
him.
No! No! 17. That okay. has to hit. I don't
sure,
know what his
hits.
Bonus is.
So give me
a
D6, please.
A million.
And a
the D8. The answer is always a million.
That's 9.
How much was on the D6?
Four.
Uh-huh. Okay. Very good. So he manages to rake at her with his claws.
We're trying.
As she moves out of the poison cloud.
Get back in there, girl.
And then she does another series of attacks.
Did I see the poison cloud have any effect on her?
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Also, you have to kill these statues because
I'm not doing it. I've already killed one.
I know, so keep going.
I feel like if we kill her, the statues will die. Zero skill, thank
Zero
you.
Zero skill, PB.
Nice.
Zero skill, peanut butter.
Zero skill.
Low ping bastard.
LPB. What'd you say? Little ping bastard?
Low ping bastard.
Low ping bastard?
Low ping.
Bastard. Ping. She has 5 more points.
As an internet connectivity.
As a little snick, snick,
you
snick.
You want a low ping for a good connection.
Oh. I didn't know that word. Fuck, there are so many things I don't know.
She begins raising her book towards you.
I love learning and reading. I'm hiding. How's she doing that?
I didn't say she actually invokes it. She just raises it towards you.
I hope she books me.
All right. Zariestra still doesn't know where the wasted lady is.
Wasted?
That's different, Tom.
Waste lady.
Oh my god, can someone read this book? Because I can't. It's vibrating.
I've had one beer, I'm wasted.
But
that's canon.
She does manage to fire an arrow that does connect.
At who?
With the waste lady.
Oh, good job, Darius.
And hello to you.
Argentum 42, thank you.
Argent.
Oh, a new sub.
Brand new.
Yay.
Brand spanking new.
You can never leave.
We couldn't handle it if you left.
Darius
so
does.
Sad.
A lot of damage.
Good job.
Oh, yeah. And hello to you.
All right.
Did you think when he said Zariestra that
hello to you.
That he actually said waste lady?
I just like their names sound so similar.
I know.
So Zariestra gets sort of this wild look in her eyes.
Fuck
and,
yeah.
And just grabs a special bolt out of her quiver and turns and like and you don't know if there's something about like the way that the leaves crinkle underneath the wasted lady's feet or exactly
she's
what it is something maybe it's just pure dumb luck, but she turns and fires this thing and the arrow goes straight into the shoulder of the wasted lady, and when it hits it makes this crackling boom of thunder.
Hell yes.
And strikes a vicious blow
that
against
is
the
great.
Waste lady.
Don't know what
also,
it is.
Thanks to chat, we have unlocked
everyone's
DM's Lament. Each player can force Tom to reroll an attack or saving throw one time.
Thank
yes.
you guys.
So I will give you these little coins as a representation.
They are
of
beauties. Thank you for the DM's Lament.
Yes. All right. Jorvin is going to, first of all, try to repel the miasma of,
miasma!
Of spirits that are swarming around him.
Whoa!
Jorvin takes 18 points of damage. He's up to 24.
You rolled max? No, reroll!
Yep, I did.
Oh, yeah, reroll!
DM's Lament, that shit. DM's Lament, Jorvin's
wow,
damage.
Wow, just in time, chat.
Yeah, just in
that
time.
That was
you can't make me reroll damage.
Yes!
It says two hit or saving throw.
A two hit then, whatever. Whatever the fuck.
I'll reroll his saving throw.
Wait, no, Havana rolls it.
Havana rolls
roll Jorvin's saving throw.
Come
please.
On.
10 plus, what do you think his bonus is?
4?
What do we...
it is a charisma save.
Oh, yeah. 4.
Well,
he's
let me
filthy.
Look. Hang on, let me look.
He's pretty charismatic.
It is a wisdom save.
4.
He has pretty good wisdom. 14. It is a DC 15.
Oh, fucking...
Okay. It meets.
All right, meets it.
Meets.
So he takes half damage. He takes 9 instead of 18.
Oh, God.
Meets.
So he's down.
Halloween.
Oh, with that video. Wait.
All right. So he's going to go over here and probably attack again.
Video? No, I'm saying like hallelujah, but Halloween.
Do you want to roll 2 attacks for Jordan?
What am I thinking of?
I don't know. Oh, I remember when I told you there was a lady who out my window for hours would go, Hallelujah!
Yeah.
Hallelujah!
What am I rolling for?
2 attacks.
Just like a neighbor who was very, who worshipped for, or something for hours.
That's a 10 and a 3. He's,
so
this is an AOE.
I assume he's at plus 5. So 15 is the best that you get. Her armor class is 17.
I'm gonna reroll this. Mm-hmm.
You
only
get
reroll.
You get one of them. I mean, one of them for sure missed.
So
Luigi
keep the 15.
Luigi's being cute.
Reroll either one of them. I don't care.
Luigi, you're being cute.
15 misses.
Oh fuck. Okay. Well.
12.
All right. So Jorven whiffs twice. Unfortunately, that brings us back to
the
top of the round.
Fuck.
Alton. All
right.
We're gonna die, guys.
No,
it's fine.
I'm doing fine.
I think if we kill the witch, the rest of the statues will die. I think she's controlling them.
I'm going to stab the statue, and that's going to be a hit. 17
okay.
plus.
Very good. It
I'll
taken
kill
0 points of damage so far.
I think it's up
okay.
to you, man.
Does...
I'm stuck in between a couple of things. Although, I think I need to wild shape real bad.
Okay, so that's going to be 7 damage.
Okay.
I'm going to wild shape, actually.
Mm-hmm. Guys, at level 5, I'm going to be able to... One more level, I can do real damage, and it's gonna be nice.
Zero skill loping bastard sends their reroll to me. Thank you very much. That
Where,
doubles the number of rerolls.
How much
that
are
I
you
have.
Paying chat to do this, Tom?
And Argentum 42 sends their reroll to Amy Vorpal.
Yay! Thank you, Argentum 42. I don't
right.
think chat anything, and they're just giving it to me.
Strum, thrum, what do you want to do?
What are you gonna do?
Do.
Okay, I want to use my bonus action to clear off the wall next to me.
Uh-huh.
And if I have the time to decipher what I think it is, I'll try and do that. If I don't, I'm just going for it. I'm just going for it. It worked well last time.
All right, very good. Why don't you give me a...
One's poison, one's fire, one's end the universe as we know it.
Why don't
one's
you...
One's like a fun perfume.
Yeah.
Why don't you give me an arcana check, please?
I'm out of rerolls, so...
I've got 2 right here.
Are you out 2?
Yeah, I spent all mine on Amy.
Amy's got 1.
I have 1. You want it? Yours. Done.
That was close.
That was close. It was like right. It was gonna work.
Better than
come, on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on.
Yeah, it is.
Fucking cock ass. Come on. 12?
Dick on a cracker.
Dick 12. On a fucking cracker.
Dick
yeah.
on a cracker.
9, 10, 11, 12, 13.
13. The only thing that you can discern from this particular set of runes is that it is something about plant growth.
Great, let's do it.
Okay.
At Waste Lady.
Okay.
I'm gonna turn her ass into a plant.
Why don't you give me an arcana check? Because you rolled badly, I'm tempted to say.
That was average. It wasn't bad. 13's not bad.
All right.
It's just not great.
Just give me an arcana check.
It's a straight C. Anyway. That's passing.
Yeah.
Skate okay. by. Become the CEO of a pharmacy company. Okay? Like
wow.
that kind of score.
Okay, Martin Shkreli. Here we go.
What
Don't.
Is that reference?
Oh, he's a piece of garbage.
He's going to jail. Don't worry.
Yeah, Martin Shkreli.
Am I going to jail?
That's what he's saying.
He was the venture capitalist guy who jacked up like EpiPens to like $4,000 yeah. a dose okay. or whatever.
I thought you were doing a burn on pharmaceuticals.
I was yes ending.
You bought a Wu-Tang M.
Well, you did it very sassily, so I couldn't tell, and I didn't get the reference.
I can't help it if I'm jaunty.
Oh, baby, I love you way.
Yes.
That is a 23. Smoke it. 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 Smoke it.
All right.
I got bras and Lena.
So this time you begin channeling the energy and a green bolt of energy passes through you. And
what does that feel like? Do I feel like aroused? Am I capable of that?
Probably.
As a bird, you do have a cloaca. But everything passes through.
No, you're
just rule for my arousal.
Your understanding of sexual reproduction is completely different than mammalian.
Yeah, you lay eggs.
Yeah.
Right.
Mm-hmm. But then you have to be fertilized.
Right. So. I mean, no, I can lay an egg without it being fertilized. It just to have a baby in it, it has to be fertilized.
Right. So there's that.
Do I lay an egg?
No, you do not. Oh. But you see this ball of
Wait, hold on. Did Amy think every time she ate an egg, she ate a baby chicken?
No, I've had this conversation. I know that every time I eat an egg, I'm eating a chicken's period.
Thank you, Mort.
Mortem interitum. In for $10.
We know you donated because that was said.
Yeah, that exact time. He's like, I'm waiting for her references. I know. And now.
It's a period because it's not fertilized, so it's just a period.
I mean, there's no blood in it.
But
usually.
But that there. But
have you ever cracked open a chicken and there's like part of a baby chicken in there?
No.
Wait, did I say crack open a chicken?
Yeah.
cracked open a chicken and you start drinking its blood before the sacrifice under the new moon.
Speaking of chicken,
and there's a baby chicken in there, like.
That I've been watching Ozark and they said, do you know where the term "stick your neck out" comes from? It's from chickens because when you're about to hack them, they actually get scared and they stick their necks further out for you to hit them, for you to whack them.
They want it ended soon.
Don't we all?
I think they're probably trying to get away.
Yeah, but that's where
they're probably not like, yeah. Do it, just do it.
Yeah. So a spiral.
Coward, do it.
So a spiral of thorns like wells up in your hand.
I'll die with honor.
And it's encrusted with tiny little almost like razor like vines, right? And again, it spools up your hand, and you can tell that there's this thick, like walnut kind of at the center of this thing, right? That's covered with little, like, scaly kind of veins and tessellations. And you throw the thing, again, toward her, but you realize, like, the power that's involved in this thing, you can't, like, hit her with it because you'd hit everybody else, right? So you throw it over here, and it spirals out 20 feet, just missing you. Just missing Zariestra, and the plants, the root seed hits the ground, and it just instantly begins like throwing out all these vines, and they begin bursting up from the ground and waving around, and they try to grasp and entangle the
nice,
the
good work.
Lady.
That is cool.
She needs to make a DC 14 strength saving throw.
Or else she dies.
Which
I think she might
am
die.
Very confident I can do. Natural 20!
Reroll.
That was a DM's lament. Uh-oh.
Wow.
Lament
DM's
away.
DM's lament!
Dirty
reflection!
Jesus Christ.
It is a weird night.
Angry players. All right. So she's
Eric's
entangled.
One drink.
Oh.
She's entangled by these grasping vines that reach.
You're about to poke your
foot. What a delicate vine.
I really feel like there's going to be a tragic accident that's ultimately my fault because I bought you a pointer.
You should have known Amy's five. I can't be trusted.
I'm not really a fidgeter, but I do like pointers.
So these grasping vines reach up and wrap around her legs, and you see that her silken robes begin to tear as they wrap around her waist, and she screeches
in
outrage.
Oh, God, it's
outrage.
An Evil Dead shit?
Lowstorm, it's your turn.
Is there something else
that you want to do? I believe you moved, but you did.
I used my bonus.
You used your action.
I didn't
move,
and I used my action, so I can move. But yeah, I think I'm just gonna try and maintain cover behind there. I don't think there's a more strategic place for me to go.
Okay.
I'm going to wild shape.
Okay.
But it's not even bedtime.
Into.
I know, this is my first actual wild shape.
I guess we'll go to bed now.
A giant snake.
A giant snake?
A giant poisonous snake.
Fight poison with poison, that's what I say.
I think I have a giant...
Wait, is she not dead?
No.
I have a giant poisonous snake. No, she's not dead. She didn't take any damage from this. She's entangled from it.
And that, unfortunately, is my action. That is not a snake. It's not a snake, Tom.
It's all right.
I don't know. It's all about perception. Please.
S'mores.
Oh yeah, and then let me eat some.
Will you heat it up?
Will you heat up two Pop-Tarts and then give Havana one of them?
So when she's entangled, is that going to mean she has disadvantage on resisting attacks?
Heat them up.
Is that what that means?
I don't believe so.
What does being entangled mean?
She's
just
restrained.
Can't move?
She is restrained, so sure, her speed is zero. Let's just take a look and find out, shall we?
Let me pull out my iPad to use next to my iPad.
What is that noise?
She is restrained, which means her speed is zero. Attack rolls against her have advantage.
I told you!
Her attack rolls have disadvantage, and she has disadvantage on dexterity saving throws.
Tom, I just need you to tell me I was right.
Okay.
Amy? You were right.
I'm the other one. The other boobies.
Boobies.
Boobies. I get one titty mag per week.
One titty man?
One titty magazine.
One titty mag? What?
I want Big Jugs USA.
Oh, hey, Pops, are you going to get her a titty mag?
No, only me. You get the other thing.
No, I don't want that.
She always gives me the articles.
That was cool, Weebus, if you're giving her a titty mag.
I'll give you one titty.
I want to rip out of a titty.
I'll rip out one titty for you. I give him the deodorant ad.
I don't even want to rip out. I want just one picture of one titty.
I gotta rip out because all the pictures have two titties in them.
Yeah, you gotta do some work. You gotta get kind of creative.
I got these craft scissors for Christmas.
Oh, fuck, you gave me one with two titties. I said one. I like odd numbers. Yeah, much better. Yeah, this one doesn't make any sense. What is it?
It's an enigma.
What is it doing all along? This is like real art. It means something.
Can't touch the one if it's all alone.
I turn into a giant snake, Tom.
All right, very good. The two statues next to you decide to pummel the crap out of you. Since you're a giant snake.
That's all she gets to do?
That's her action.
I'm going to move.
She's got to move, man. She's got a bonus action.
Yeah, I'm going to provoke.
But what's your AC when you're a dragon?
It's not better.
Or when you're a snake.
It's a little better. It's 12. Oh, no, that's the same. Oh, no, no, it's not. It's 14. It's 14. It's 14. It's better.
Okay. It's a little better. It's -1.
I get that hard snake back.
One of them misses.
They both miss.
No, 11 plus 5 is 16.
Okay. All right.
What is your health at? I'm slithering away.
Oh, it's fine. She's a snake now.
I'm a snake now, so we're back up to 11 hit points.
Wow. Drama.
You're okay, buddy.
Oh, drama.
You're okay.
He got scared.
Yeah, he got scared. He bumped the...
embarrassed or something.
He got scared.
Well, I'm pretty embarrassed.
He doesn't like stuff touching
his butt. Embarrassing, Luigi.
Idiot.
9 points of damage as its fist slams into you.
Okay, great.
Also, give me a DC 12 constitution save.
Okay, do I have con? I do. I have con as a... 13 is plus 2.
13 is plus 1.
13 is plus 1.
Yeah.
10, 1. Oh, yeah, plus 1. Okay.
This one a little bit.
Right. Okay, I miss.
Okay.
And I want to never touch this cream.
All right. you now are restrained.
Wait, what the dick? Moved into it?
No, I tried to get away and the cons, they failed.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So you...
Guys, I'm not much help in this fight.
You feel your flesh begin to stiffen up, and you almost become, encased in this
hard. Oh, they oozed you.
Yeah, yeah. This the extremely rigid sheath of slate.
Okay.
It's
so I'm
your skin is beginning to turn to stone. You watch it like.
But I'm a snake.
Even snake. Though you're a snake, you can tell that your snake skin is beginning to.
Goliaths are pretty much already made from stone, so I think maybe she would be immune to this sort of attack.
Yeah. All right. My snake also has tattoos, and anyone with tattoos knows that they're basically extra armor. What are you looking at the clock for, Tom?
No reason.
Am I boring you?
Don't worry.
You want to talk about cheaty mags again?
Your armor class is 14.
Why are you?
Yeah. You already hit me.
That was an AOO. It's now their turn.
Well, I moved, didn't I? No, I didn't move.
No, you start to turn to stone.
Fucking fuck. Okay.
You're restrained though, so that's one set of attacks that misses you. The other set of attacks has advantage. That hits you.
Well.
2d6 plus 3. Do you want to use a DM's lament on that?
How are you doing, Amy? Do you need a
I think I'll be okay. Yeah. No,
8 points of damage.
So that's I turned to a snake and just as soon I'm back to low storm.
if you take damage, you lose wild shape.
Yeah. So my
no, if you get down to zero in your wild shape.
Yeah, you're fine. You're a snake.
No, I know. I have 11 hit points. I definitely have surpassed that. He hit me for 9 points the first time.
Yeah.
So what is
it? It is 8 points.
8 points minus. So
well, but I can
six.
Make him reroll if you want to see if he can stay a snake.
No, that's okay. I really just wanted to get out of there.
I bet you confused him.
I don't know what, I think they weren't quite sure.
Precious Angel, he's gonna knock over that camera.
I don't think so.
I think he's scared of everything.
That's true.
Okay,
come here, lay down.
Fine, they do that.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Fine, I'll allow it.
And one of them attacks Alton. Can he hit? No, he cannot.
Nobody can hit Alton.
All right, I'll
this is so frustrating.
Yeah.
Now how I feel most battles.
We shouldn't have gotten into combat before our long rest.
We did do it on purpose.
Yeah, we're like, let's set up a trap.
We're fine.
We had a great idea.
I don't think Jay would have put us through this.
Give me a saving throw for Jorvin, please.
Jorvin, I'm sorry. 8 plus 100.
It's a wisdom save.
4. 8 plus 4, 12.
That's not enough.
Are you cheating?
The DC on this is...
Okay, if you're going to get her a chitty mag, I at least get a grilled cheese.
15.
Cocked.
That's cocked. Sure, works out better for me. 8 plus 5 is 13 points of damage for Jorvin.
No Pop-Tart.
He's up to 28. He's taken 28. Dom, can you tell me how many hit points total Jorvin has?
No, you're his dad now.
Is he giving you a hug?
No, he probably
it's not in the...
Wants to go home.
Something?
Sure.
All right.
Is he in chat?
What was the old score?
Tell Tom I want to leave.
You're not going to kill Jorvin when he's not here.
Yeah, Tom.
It doesn't matter.
I'm going to heal everybody.
He has 100 hit points.
Oh, okay.
I have to heal one person. I think it'll be
629.
Oh, all right. So 69. He's one more hit will probably knock 69 him out.
69 is a funny number, guys.
Yeah. It's like sex. I've done it.
I don't know if you know why 69 is a funny number.
Yeah, sex.
Like this.
Yeah, that.
Like
yeah.
This.
When you put your hands together.
Clap. It was because the sex was so good.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that happens to me all the time with all the sex.
She's going
to
stab at Zariestra twice more.
32, Tom says.
Ooh, 32. He's taking 28. He's on the brink. So that's a miss because of disadvantage, and that is also a miss because of disadvantage.
And a crit miss, and he punches himself in the face because he's
confused. No, he punches himself in the dick. That's a 69.
All right.
It tracks.
Zariestra fires an arrow, and...
Zariestra's the best!
Unfortunately...
And hello to you.
Disadvantage.
And hello to you.
Still misses.
Disadvantage. Why? She's at disadvantage. She
Why is she at disadvantage?
But
she can't see.
But
her.
The waist lady is restrained, so attacks against her has advantage.
Amy, you did something.
That's my best one.
17.
I feel so good! Yes!
Amy, you cheated the system.
No, I played the system rules. Correctly.
You're a hero. All right.
It looks like I'm not listening, but I'm tracking every little dial.
Okay, you're like Winona Ryder at the Oscars.
Okay, so she does 7 points of damage.
Have you seen the one where there's pizza?
Yeah, flying around.
And then it's just like, she eats
it in her mouth.
And,
so good.
She draws another arrow out of her quiver and fires this thing, and instead of an explosion of sound, there's this enormous, like, explosion of a stringy green goop.
Jesus!
That, like, that flies all over the waist lady. And suddenly, at this point, like, she can see, like, the outline of the waist lady. She's like, oh, there she is! And she draws another arrow, and she fires again. This time she...
Extra.
Oh yeah, we have to clap like normal people. 69 clap.
69 clap.
All right.
And hello to you.
Does somebody else want to roll the damage for this?
That means that you
Or do you want me to roll the damage?
You have sex.
No, it's working.
You can roll the damage.
If you can't hear it, you have an outside.
All right.
No, it's very loud for me.
She fires an explosive arrow.
Girl, get it.
At the creature.
I like you, Zariestra. Mm-hmm.
And hello to you,
You're my friend. I'm not doing any work in this battle. None.
Hey, you turned into a snake burp.
And you made the earth tumble.
Hey, you really shook things up.
I feel the earth move under my feet.
Crit.
Wow.
That crit, though, there's 10, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18.
I feel like you could have done better, Azar.
I didn't say I was done.
Wait, why? Why is
so
that?
So 18,
does she
20.
A million.
28 D6s? Points of damage.
Does she die? Now does she die? Boom. Waste Lady.
Oh, she's definitely dead.
Waste Lady dead.
I can see the tracking.
And zero? Is it negative now?
It's negative. But Zariestra also dies.
90 points of damage.
Ooh!
She is not looking good, but she is not dead.
God. What? I'm looking at the... I'm cheating the wrong way.
Who wants to roll for Jarvan's attacks?
I don't know if I should do it anymore.
Eric, you
do it.
They're at advantage. That's the good news.
Okay. Eric, do it.
One does a D6 plus a D8.
I feel like he should have had advantage this whole time since
we're in the
same
I still smile one.
19 for the first one.
Thank you for the first sub
19
ever.
19 for the second one.
They both hit.
Wow, Eric. God, good job.
And then D6, D8 for first attack. That's 8... 9, 10, 11, plus whatever.
11 plus 4, is that what you said?
Sure.
Yep.
15.
And then the second attack is just the D8.
It's a D6, I believe.
Oh, yeah, just a D6.
There's no way it's before
6.
Hit.
Okay. What was the first D6?
The first D6 was a 2.
Wait.
It was a 2?
What was the total of the last one?
8. It was 8 plus something. Plus 3.
Right.
Okay. That D6 should have been halved.
Okay.
But either way, it's more than 10 points total, right?
Yeah.
All right. So, Jarvan plunges to his two weird dagger fists into the side of the...
Don't claw shame him.
Would someone like to describe how he dispatches the waste lady?
No, you don't.
Okay.
Eric made a... He made the roll.
I imagine he... claws in the middle and just tears her in half.
He Wolverines her?
Yeah.
That is so not
so
on
his
brand.
Claws find purchase in her brittle elven ribs and he just shreds them apart.
He's very
He Wolverined her!
Yeah, but he's got ghosts in his mind or something right now, so he's weird.
Oh, he does have ghosts in him.
What? His what?
Yeah, she showed him a ghost lantern and he's all crazy now.
It wasn't a ghost lantern, I just
it's,
yelled the
it's
word
a book.
Lantern.
No, there's a book.
Don't just take whatever I say and think it's true.
Okay.
I trust you implicitly.
Well, that's wrong.
All right. So,
I have inspiration I haven't used.
He dispatches the waste lady at this point.
Yay.
She crashes to the ground and.
All right, Kyle, you're welcome back now.
you see a spirit issue out through her mouth and then her book, like, closes, like, goes kathunk closed. And then it begins to rapidly disintegrate and decay into just like shreds of pulp and ground powder.
What the fuck?
As that happens, then these three hulking statues also begin to crack and suddenly like weather as if like hundreds and hundreds of years are, of the elements are passing over them, and they fall and disintegrate into chunks of burned out, worthless stone.
Hey, Santa, just now. All right.
You did great.
I cut still smile one, so the reroll two, Havana Mahoney.
Thank you, smile.
Thank you. I still smile.
Not me.
And Zariestra stands over the wasted lady and pulls a flask from her.
Hello to you.
From her belt pouch, and sprinkles the remains of the body with Greek fire, and it instantly catches flames.
Wow!
And you see this
Greek fire,
oily gray smoke. Yeah, alchemist fire.
Grease lightning.
it's basically like yield in time napalm.
Curls of this oily black smoke begin curling up into the air.
Does it make a noise?
Oh, he loves you, Eric.
It sounds and it smells like somebody like butter burning in a hot skittle.
Ooh. But so good, really good.
Oh, does it smell like butter?
Is it what is it smelling?
Yeah.
It smells like butter.
You wouldn't care if breakfast was sitting right in front of your face.
It smells like more like burnt lard or fat.
Did a snake just insult me?
She's not a snake. She was a snake for literally
3 seconds. I tried to be a snake, but yes, the gods...
Sorry, I'm being attacked by this wild deer.
The gods did not have that in their plan for me today. Not worthy as a snake, turns out.
I did pretty well.
Zariestra says, regardless of your worth as a snake or whatever form you may choose to take, you've certainly proven your worth today. I had no idea where that foul creature was until...
Yeah, you saw it right away!
I'm very perceptive.
How did you not see her? Are you immune to... I mean, there she was, bright
inside. I didn't see her either, but I was also engaged in combat.
I didn't see her, but then I turned around and I did. You know?
I was hyper-focused on the statues trying to kill me, but I didn't let them touch me.
I suspect that... part of her special curse is that she could render herself invisible to my people.
Is Amy still part stone?
Give me another constitution saving throw. DC 12.
9 plus 2 is 11, so...
Your limbs begin to, like, feel very heavy and leaden.
Okay, but my spirits are just as high.
Yeah, but you're starting to stoop over.
Okay, it hurts.
And you're feeling your flesh begin to
stiffen.
Okay,
well, make it stop, Tom.
Give me another constitution save.
Yeah, I didn't let them touch me either. They just did. If it were up to me, I said no. I cocked.
Critical. This is how it feels when you win.
It's an 11.
It's a 20. It's a 20.
All right, Amy.
No, it is, though.
If you say so.
All right, it's fine.
We all got real chill, because I win the game.
All right.
Just let her have it.
It's a 20! Fuck!
So here's the thing.
Bone in 1 equals 20. Noted.
Yeah. 1, 1, 2.
Your skin is beginning to turn to stone. Normally you would become a statue in 24 hours. You have critted on your thing, so you think it may take longer than that. But you're going to need some sort of magical healing or restoration in order to avoid this.
Mm-hmm. Ooh.
Wait, was this not going to be a problem until I brought it up?
I kind of forgot about it, but that's okay. I appreciate your honesty.
I don't.
I do.
What do we call this? Almost statue? Wear statue?
Call it a stone arse.
You'll be petrified in 6 days.
Guess you're not worthy. Getting all turned to stone and all.
Whoa. Come here, buddy. Come on.
Mom.
Come here.
Right.
Hey.
Mom. Right. So.
Why would you say that about me in my head? Get it off my head.
Who's she talking to?
I don't know.
I'm not. Of course I'm worthy.
Oh, Jarvan, did you rip that woman apart? Good job.
I need help, Zariestra.
I killed her.
Jarvan.
Whoa, I thought that was Zariestra. Yeah.
That's good. You really ripped her in half. That's quite impressive.
Come on, buddy.
Normally you're not good at that level of violence.
I think it was the mushrooms.
Oh, I think it is too. Listen, guys, I don't feel very good. Everything in my body is getting real stiff and stuff. Oh, yeah. I mean, I'm like, you know, I've got pretty good skin, but feel this.
Oh, yeah, it's baby soft. Oh, no, your skin is actually quite hard right now.
Yes, that's what I'm saying.
Did you say that first thing?
Yes, wait.
I don't touch you all when you're sleeping. That'd be weird. You're weird. Shut up.
Okay.
Oh, Otis.
Yep.
What the fuck?
What do I feel like?
I mean, if I had to guess, you would be soft, soft feathers.
Are you checking your nose?
I don't know. I mean, it's soft, a very downy feel, but not that I would have any notes.
Right.
Jarvan is lumpy. Yeah. I would guess. I don't know.
Do you say lumpy?
Yeah.
No, there's not a... What does that even mean? He's got lumps.
I don't know. These are all guesses and certainly not notes that I've taken about each and every one of you.
This is a weird character development.
Yeah. Yeah. You're fine.
It's not gonna get you. It's not gonna get you, baby.
The dog that was scared of the shelf.
Maybe he should be a little shorter. It wouldn't be an issue.
Yeah. Idiot.
Oh, there's no question my dog is not smart. Come on, lay down. Yep.
He cute though. Is Zariestra going to reply?
I'm sorry, what did you ask her?
I want help.
Come on, buddy.
I'm gonna turn into a statue like one of those things. I'm gonna start oozing green ooze and I'm not ready for that. I haven't even been found my fairy. I can't go like this.
I must say, it would be quite a
You have done a great favor to my people. I will confer with our shaman and see if there's something we can do.
Yeah, please do. I can't go like this. It's not my time.
Maybe there's a spell on one of these pillars. I used a couple of them to fight the wasteland.
Yeah, I saw that. That was amazing. You did that.
There's spells on this pillar.
I mean, I guess that's what they are, or incantations, or I'm not sure, but they certainly helped. Maybe there's one on here, and if this is the only pillar, maybe there's more pillars. I mean, I don't read Elvish, but maybe we could see if there's a cure for, if since the statues were here, you know, maybe there's a spell that turns people this way, and maybe there's a spell that fixes them.
Okay, so she puts two fingers in her mouth and gives, like, this piercing whistle.
Oh, jeez.
And suddenly one of the other green treaders arrives in short order. And they have this sort of, like, whispered conversation in Elvish, right? Why don't you give me an intelligence check just straight up to see if you can pick up any of it, because it happens very fast and it happens under their breath.
Okay, the Bardic Inspiration, that's going to give me a 17.
Are you mad? Welcome.
Yeah, are you mad, Tom?
17.
17 total.
You're mad as
all right.
And can I, sorry, just to like aid in this, can I know I can't understand them, but can I just do a perception check just to like pick up on the, like reading their faces, like their emotion or the...
You can't do a perception check, you can do an insight check.
Oh, sorry, yeah,
like.
Insight, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I'm good at that too.
Mm-hmm.
Plus 6. Oh, farts, 9.
9 total. You know, part of it is that their culture is so isolated, it's very alien to you. And part of it is they're just not really, like, facing the right way for you to kind of pick up on all this stuff, right? But you do pick up, like, he's gravely wounded. I'm not sure he's going to make it. Like, those are two things that you managed to pluck out of this conversation, right? I think they think you're a man.
You can tell by the
cadence?
No, you can tell
gestures.
You can tell by the pronouns that they're using that they're talking about a royal he, like,
oh, yeah.
they're probably referring to their leader.
Okay.
Right? But you can't pick out, like,
do they also think I'm the queen? A male
probably,
queen.
Probably
it's called
not.
A king. Is it though?
I think their leader is injured.
So Zariestra turns to you and she has sort of this grave look on her face and she says,
And hello to you.
We shall be returning to our dwellings. I cannot formally invite you there, but I can allow you to make...
Casually invite us?
I can't allow
can
you to...
Can you tell us the exact location? And
to make...
Maybe we just happened to come by.
You said you were... The
like
shaman.
If we were visiting some friends who were in the area and would say, oh, are you invited here? Oh, it's so strange running into you here.
Maybe we're just going on a walk.
I am very sympathetic to your desires. However, I am not formally in charge here at the moment. So there are certain traditions which must be obeyed, and you are already pushing the bounds of our people's flexibility.
Oh, thank you.
Yes. Well, you have achieved something remarkable here
today.
Yeah,
we've only destroyed your greatest enemy. You're right.
Yes.
Undeserving of a basic decency. You're right.
No, Alton, that's not what she's saying. She's saying that we shouldn't even be in this forest. It's not even, we're not even meant to be here. But the truth
is, we do
need to get to deal with, and I need to get this stone out of my skin.
Yes, well, it seems our shaman shall be busy this evening.
What the? What? Fine, what about next evening?
No, I believe
she was saying she's
I believe
she's
saying
you.
They first have to care for their own, and then once that is done, then they can care for you.
Oh, I thought you said
no,
they're busy.
It wasn't like hey, when are you? Oh, I'm busy that day. No, thank you.
Sorry, she's really aggro.
Yeah.
Am I?
She's worried she'll become a statue before she gets her fairy. It's a whole thing.
Yes,
I'm
worried.
Literally everybody we conquer.
Well, she said she might be busy. And that's a mean thing to say. If you're
but
not going
to... But if someone is busy, not everybody has to say yes to you, Lowstern.
No, but we just helped so hard. We helped so hard.
You did. You helped so hard. And we're going to get you the help you need. Don't worry.
Are you begging for help?
Yeah, I'm not above this. Oh, I might be.
Yeah. All right. So, Zariestria kind of like, you know, circles everybody up and you begin retreating further deeper into the woods. Wormdrake, Risa!
Wormdrake!
Thank you.
One
thing that immediately strikes you is that where previously you had a group of approximately two dozen of these Green Treader elves who were accompanying you, now there's only five.
Whoops.
Right. And
six
you,
if you count me.
You do see, well,
not
five.
Not a Green Treader elf.
Dressed
you're not a
one.
Green Treader elf.
Trust this one.
Five and a half.
Faker.
Thank you.
Poser.
You do see that they have fashioned a rudimentary litter, and that the leader that you had encountered earlier is laying in it, and his skin is completely pale.
Was he on the trip with us?
Yeah.
He's one of the, probably one of the few that went,
oh my God.
Yeah, and he's got this, like, he's got he's got a bandage wrapped around his neck that is soaked with blood still.
Can I heal him?
I don't
walk?
Know if you want to.
Yeah, I have Blood of the Font or whatever it's called. Circle of Font. What are we? Bomb of the Court. You know. Yeah,
that's
Bomb of the Summer Court.
Okay.
I can do four.
Did that changeling thing?
This is for free. Huh?
No.
What the fuck? What's
summer,
wrong?
Summer Court is a changeling thing.
Oh, got it.
Like...
You a changeling?
Nah, bro.
You gotta tell us.
Seven. Yeah, it took me a cop.
So 8, so 15.
You heal him 15 points of damage?
Yeah, 15 hit points.
Okay.
Can you walk? Can she walk?
Yeah, she's just like...
I don't...
Just like she cracky?
She got 6 days before she's full statue.
Yeah, so normally, like, over the course of a day, she would turn into a statue, but in this case, it's taking it a much longer. But she does walk stooped, and you can tell that it's hard for her to, like, lift her arms up, because all the weight starts at the end of your extremities, right? So your feet, you shuffle your feet because your feet are really heavy, and your arms are kind of, like, very pendulous and, like, clumsy to work with.
Hey, let me at him!
You knock somebody out.
Sorry!
But regardless of that, you manage to go over there and you know, convince them that you know some healing magic, and... they don't have any reason to doubt you. They're familiar with what druidic magic is. So they let you tend to their leader. You channel your healing energy into him, and suddenly he, you know, his eyes pop open, and you can tell it, like, the color returns to his skin, and his eyes pop open, and for a moment he's like frightfully afraid of this stranger who's touching him. But then he reaches up and kind of instinctively claws at his neck, right? And he realizes that, oh, he had this horrible wound, which is now, like, closed up. And he might have literally been on the brink of death.
You've got a job to do, sir. You've got to keep living.
He looks at you, and he reaches up, and he puts his hand around the back of your neck.
Deep kiss.
He pulls you down, and he pulls your head next to his mouth.
It's happening.
Oh, this is so magical. Just she finally found her fairy.
Well, his head goes completely, like, past your cheek.
Oh, this is so awkward.
And he nestles his nose into your ear, and you hear him whisper, Quillator.
What'd you call me?
What the fuck you say?
Well, and a Quillatora to you. I'm sorry. Keep going. Go on. I'm listening.
He says, my name is Quillatora Kalar.
Okay. Lawnwood, Lowstorm, Big Bubba Bicker.
May your tribe ever be blessed.
Oh.
By the Green Treader.
Oh. Well, that's very nice.
You have saved my life.
Well, sure, I mean... Yeah, you have...
You have not only proven yourself worthy by slaying the Waste Lady, but you have broken centuries of mistrust.
By healing you?
You had no reason to heal me. You committed an act of pure generosity. You have shown me mercy when I would not have shown you any.
I bet 5 gold she screws this up in the next 5 minutes.
Yeah, but she accidentally punches him in the face with her weird, heavy hands.
And therefore, I invite you into my clan.
Whoa, what?
I invite you.
She yells.
To become a Green Treader.
All of us? Us three?
Four?
Oh yeah, Joven's here. Whatever. No one mentioned this.
I murdered a lady.
I murdered the lady.
All four of you.
Wow.
I've already got the outfit.
That is amazing. So,
I don't think we hear this coming.
Do they hear it?
No. He's he's literally, like, got his...
Is he speaking
one of those
Elvis
things,
though?
You know when they're one of those things where somebody's, like, either, like, really old or really sick,
yeah,
and they kind of, like, clam onto you,
yeah,
and, like, just sort of, like, you know...
Hate that.
Yeah. Oh. Well, that's what he's
not
doing.
A fan of deathbed grabs.
That's what he's doing to you.
Okay, wow.
They're whispering a lot.
Yeah, that's
should
very nice
whisper?
Of you.
Yeah, sure.
I'll have to talk about it. Do we need to accept, or are we already in? Is there a ceremony? There's always these ceremonies.
There would be a ceremony tonight.
Okay, all right. I think this sounds good. Here's the thing. I'm turning into a statue. I can feel it in my skin. It's slow, but how's your butt?
It's a six.
He says, unfortunately, this magic to cure you is beyond the ken of our shaman. But
Amy,
I know someone who should be able to help you.
Don't say the Grand Druid, he's dead.
No, he's dead. Is it Dilwith?
His name is Dilwith.
Dilwith, we've got to get him for like 5 reasons now. Alright, yeah. Okay, I'm going to tell everyone, alright?
Yes.
Friends.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
Sorry, we're over here telling secrets. So
why would you do that? Hey, what did
I
you say?
I made a stew.
What did you say?
How?
Tell me.
What? I was going to make stew, but now I'm dealing with the reality that I ripped someone in half.
Well, there was this big pile of burning bones, and I thought, well, why waste a good fire? And so I found some mushrooms, and I happened to have this dead squirrel in my office.
I'm not eating that.
That's probably the best impression you've ever done.
I'm not going to eat that, Jovan.
So, Lowstorm, did you screw this up?
Well, if you call getting invited into another clan screwing it up.
No, oh, well, I think if her clan found out that she joined another clan, they probably would kick her out.
Oh, yeah, okay, so we'll call it even.
Oh, okay, yeah. Sure, yeah.
What's happening.
Because we don't know yet.
No, we don't know.
Well, it wasn't just me, but I think I did icing to it. I didn't do much in the fight. The king. Quelladora Kukar.
Kukar. Amy, I told you not to try and do this in front of people.
Quelladora Kukar.
Kukar?
Kukar.
What is her name?
His name. So he loves the way you fought. He loves the way you fought. He loves the way I healed him. Without question. Which, that raises another question. I think I'm learning, because normally, if you're gonna die, you're just meant to die. But I went all out and just put all of that aside and saw a wounded warrior and healed him.
Maybe Jorvin and I are having a positive influence on you.
Yeah. Maybe some people are not meant to die. Maybe you're just worthy just because you are.
Yeah. But I mean, there's still plenty of people that deserve to die.
Okay, I'll go with you there.
I mean, we can...
The waste lady deserved to die.
Yeah, she was pure evil, mate.
Yeah, you really, like that was impressive, Jorvin. Yeah, like, I would have just, like, stabbed her and she would have died, but you, like, you took effort to make it hurt.
Well, what I decided to do was stop resisting all of those weird spirits that were flying around and trying to dissolve my essence, and I just inhaled one, and it made me a lot stronger.
No, that can't be true. Jorvin, is it in you now?
I don't know.
I mean, I also feel like I really contributed to, like, weakening her.
Yeah, you did fantastic.
Yeah, you did great.
Like, getting her in a weakened state. I don't know that you...
You tapped all of those marvelous elven obelisks.
Yeah.
That was amazing.
Okay.
Let's be clear. I did literally nothing.
No, you made the earth shake. One of them fell down a little bit.
And you turned into a snake for a second.
I mean, turn into a snake.
It's not that I didn't do anything. I mean, I tried a lot of things. They just didn't have an effect. However, what Quelladora Kukar says...
It can't be correct. What is the name?
It's Quelladora Kalar.
Kalar. Well, anyway, he loved that I healed him. And I love that too. About myself.
Generosity is...
Yeah, he said that. He said I was generous.
Yeah.
He liked that.
You are.
But isn't that weird? In our clan, we just leave people... If they're going to die, they're going to die. They'll figure it out or not, you know? Well,
yeah, but who says they're going to die? If you heal them, then maybe they are worthy. Maybe you're the one who decides Who's worthy?
You know why I did it? It was selfish. I knew that this was the decision maker that was going to get the shaman to heal me.
Well, maybe we shouldn't have this conversation in front of them.
No, I mean, all right. I was just telling you what was going through my mind.
You don't need to say everything that comes into your mind.
No, I don't. But don't you think that's weird that I thought maybe he would...
No, self-preservation is a very common thing. I do it all the time.
That's literally all Alton does.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yes, right. Well, you're not the person I admire most in this party.
Wow. But have you seen his butt?
Let's have a look. You're moving on up, chap. Moving up the list of who I admire most in this party.
All right. So
I don't have a butt.
Oh, no.
I have a hole.
Listen, deep down you have a butt. A wonderful butt deep inside.
I don't know if you saw my butt when I was a snake. I have a butt every time I turn into an animal.
I must say, it's disturbing.
Lisa Hannawalt is, she's an artist. She does the character art for BoJack Horseman, too. But she's a great artist in general, and she does this drawing of a snake with tits, and it's so funny. Gotta check out that titty snake.
All right, so you travel about 2 hours through the woods here, and...
how many casualties were there?
Well, there was 24, and now there's only 5, right?
Don't make us do the math.
19 of them got killed by this one.
Wow.
What are you asking me for? I don't know.
Does anybody have a calculator?
I
have a lie detector.
What am I, a robot?
So part of it is you don't know how many were killed before you even noticed that those were getting killed, right?
Aww.
So those coughs that you noticed were probably some of the last ones.
The important thing is that we're all alive, and nothing happened to me.
But that was, oh my God, something was supposed to happen to you.
What?
That was the plan that I came up with, and it wound up killing everyone. Let's not mention that either.
You just did.
I think we mixed
company.
The best possible outcome. Fun. We survived.
All right. So you arrive at the Green
Jordan
Treader.
Only had to eat one ghost.
Did
you curse fucking Kyle while he's out of town?
Yeah, of course. You arrive at the Green Treader Village. You ascend a series of... steps and ladders and actually go up into the tree canopy up above, right? The silver mist is still just as oppressive up above in the tree canopy as it is below, right? But there is a combination of feasting, because Quilladora has clearly given the indication that they're going to indoctrinate some new members into the tribe tonight. But it's mixed with this tinge of melancholy sadness at the fallen warriors who were sacrificed to the Waste Lady today. So it's a bittersweet occasion. They make this fairly... It's startling how good it smells for it being completely like vegetarian. Like they put together this broth and they introduce honey into it, and they're cooking this enormous vegetable stew, which absolutely smells amazing, right?
I couldn't possibly, you know, to honor the dead, I'll
you eat like a carrot cube?
Well, so you each get, assuming that you accept, you each get indoctrinated into the Green Treader.
Yeah, do we get a tattoo or anything?
Thing. So they give you a... They each want to give you something special, right? So they give you a tattoo of a curling vine that goes all the way kind of like down your arm, and it shows the vine at the top of your palm. It is wrapped around a boulder and just cracking a bunch of rocks, right? Splitting
cool.
that apart.
Yeah.
You do notice that, like, you've had tattoos, obviously a lot of tattoos before.
Yes.
And although you often shrug off the pain, you notice that they have a lot of difficulty applying to the ink as your skin is beginning to thicken and whatnot, right? The upside is you don't feel hardly any of this process at all.
So that's what they give you. Jorvan asks for an assortment of elven mushrooms and various other spices and is given a large packet or almost like a small kit of exclusive spices that they have harvested from their portion of the forest. For Strumthrum, they give you a handful of small diamonds, right? But the diamonds come in a silk pouch. But it's not like a normal pouch that has a drawstring and an opening on it, right? It's like a silken handkerchief that they teach you this elven command word and it folds up onto itself to form a pouch. The four corners like all join and like intertwine into this intricate, almost like Celtic knot. And that's kind of cool, right? Like
it's really cool.
Yeah, they show it to you and like, they teach you the words to knot it and unknot it. And then Zariestra says, just wait. And she teaches you one more elven word, and it is the elven word essentially for sparkle, right? And she throws it into the air, and she throws the pouch into the air, and she says the kind of like open and sparkle elven words, whatever they are, in rapid succession, which of course you can instantly memorize with your mimicry trick, right? And when this happens, they freeze in midair and slowly begin kind of like spiraling around in a circle.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, that's awesome. Siak.
And Quilladora, it comes to your turn to be indoctrinated into the tribe.
Oh, hello to you.
And he looks at you, and then he reaches down, and he's got some sort of silk pouch on his belt pouch, right? And you haven't spent much time with him at all. And he is still sort of recovering from his various wounds, but he's sitting in this ornate wooden chair, which is clearly like his special ceremonial chair. And he reaches into his belt pouch and manipulates a couple things, and he comes out with this carved ivory pipe. And he hands it to you. And he also then gives you a package that's made out of large, broad folded leaves. And he folds the things over and he hands that to you. And when you open it up, it's almost like a little leaf envelope, and you can tell that it is elven pipeweed inside.
Pipeweed? Pipeweed.
Damn.
Pipeweed? Pipeweed.
And so he looks around you and...
Try to smoke it. I sniff it out.
he looks around.
Blind Seer?
And, yes, Blind Seer gives their reroll to Eric Riker. Thanks for the bits as well. That's for you. And he says, I want to thank you all for saving my life and saving my people. The corruption of that creature, she would have slowly killed each and every one of us, and our portion of the Ironwood would have fallen to the Gnolls and the Minotaurs, and our tribe would have been extinguished. We lost many brave and noble warriors today, but I am proud to say that we have added four new brave and noble warriors to our tribe.
I do a very deep bow.
Okay.
Well said.
And so, where does your journey take you next? I am sorry that we cannot cure the curse that has befallen you.
Yeah, that was not great, but... What about, you talked to your shaman already?
Yes.
But then onwards, we already were seeking to with the druid so that he might be able to point us to the fallen star.
The fallen prophecy, the books of prophecy.
And to show him the books of prophecy?
No, he can unlock.
He can unlock them.
He can help us unlock.
He can help us. Anyway, he can help us. And then also, I've got to get fixed.
Yes.
And then,
as I said, we have not had contact with Durwith. We have been an isolated people, and Durwith is a half-elf, and normally that is a blasphemy to our people. But perhaps this is an attitude which we shall revisit.
Damn. Yep. If only it was this easy.
We do not have... any sort
father.
Of relationship with Durwith, but there is something perhaps that you can offer him which he will see as a token of peace or gratitude. And he gestures, and Zerestria comes forward. And she gives you her bow.
Was she good too?
You know, it's a good question. Yeah, probably gives it to you.
I mean, I fired two really good arrows.
she kneels down and hands it to you. She says, it is a piece of exquisite craftsmanship, and its equal has not been seen in our village in 200 years. But if this is what it takes to make peace between our people and the Druid of Cwm Sernant, then it is a sacrifice which we find worthy.
Alton says, thank you for this honor in Elvish.
All right. Very good. So, with that, there are some further celebrations and whatnot, but you essentially crash down for the night.
I definitely want to perform at the party.
Oh, okay. All right. Why don't you give me a performance check, and do you know what kind of performance you're going to do? You can play a song, or...
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I was like, what do you mean?
I'm gonna be a giant snake and dance with her.
Okay, great.
Ooh.
All right. So you have an advantage on your performance check. Are there any particular elements of the song that you want to incorporate into the song?
I want to play it on my little guitar that has the heart piece cut out of the middle.
Mm-hmm.
And I just want it to be a very renowned song of, like, celebration and unity. That I would have learned in my bardic studies that would resonate with many cultures. Performance, I think it's going to be like an 18 or something.
Probably pretty good.
Oh, actually a dirty 20.
Oh, all right. Great. Yeah. And so they're very, the chief is very grateful and impressed by your ability to sort of like tell the tale of what transpired here and how these people whose eyes were formerly closed to the wider world have now had a whole new vista opened up before them.
It is the Black Eyed Peas. Where's the love? That's what it is. Where's the love that love?
All right.
Alton wants to get hammered and find someone to make a few mistakes with tonight.
All right, you're going to have to give me, let's see, give me, you know, just give me a straight charisma check.
Okay.
Okay. I guess, or persuasion, if you want to do persuasion.
I mean, that probably would do it, but thank you, Volunteer. Good thing I'm pretty good at charisma, persuasion, so that's going to be 13.
13.
Well, you get a little too drunk. You got elven wine goggles, as they say.
This is
going to
be
Lurb
2.0.
Yeah. He turned out to be pretty cool.
Except he had a demon inside of us that's been causing problems.
But hey, at least he's not boring.
That's true. And that's why I left him.
I feel like this turns into one of those situations where...
In the morning, I'm like, oh, this wasn't... I'm sorry, I didn't... This isn't what I...
No, you rolled a 13. They do that to you.
Okay. Yeah, I know. I'm not...
It ends awkwardly, regardless of what happens.
What is your face? What's happening? What's transpiring here?
Nothing.
All right.
You look angry.
I do.
Yeah.
What is happening here?
I'm trying to figure out what happens.
So the next morning.
For him.
You may never know. Only those inside the bedchamber.
In my interpretation, he ends up finding somebody, but it's clearly somebody who's probably like low status in the tribe, like somebody who's it's essentially like a groupie kind of thing where they're clearly more into it than he probably was, yeah. And also like the rest of the village kind of would look down on like this person or whatever.
I don't know if we're gonna see
what
these people
he again. Rolled low. The other person didn't roll low.
I'm part of the tribe, but I'm still a half-elf.
Yeah, exactly.
Here's how I interpret it. You get with someone super high status, you think it went really well, and the sex is really good, and they totally, like, just peace out
they
right
just
afterwards.
Ghost on
don't
you.
Say anything. Seem really uninterested.
Yeah.
So you gotta do it with someone high status, but they just completely think you're insane.
Only their needs were met. A little bit of...
Okay, so first thing in the morning, Zariastra kind of like leads up a group
good day to you too.
Of eight other green treaders, and you have a fantastic breakfast, and away you go off through the woods. She apparently knows some. So what's strange to you is you expect that. Oh, okay, it's time for us to make our journey, over to the Druid's Grove. We'll go back down the ladders and the stairways and go back down onto the... That does not happen. You begin to, step over into different parts of the trees, and there are these long, almost like willow-type branches, right? And they form, this veil, and she keeps, just diving, you follow a tree branch that's fairly wide, right? So you follow this path through this tree branch, and there's this enormous veil of willow branches that covers one portion of the branch, and she just sort of slips between them, and the rest of the elves are like, "Let's go," and you slip between them, and as you're walking through them, you can kind of feel this strange tingling sensation, right? That kind of sparkles and rubs up against you, almost like the trees are vibrating with life, right? And each step that you take seems to go a little bit faster and a little bit faster. Like, a great analogy would be when you're on one of those slide walk people mover things, and you start walking on them. You know how you compared to everybody, then there's somebody next to you who's just walking up, on the carpet.
Yeah,
They're just walking on the carpet, and you're walking on the thing almost like you're propelled by it. You have that same exact feeling as you pass through these long tunnels of just drooping willow branches and leaves. And occasionally you emerge into kind of like a nexus of the treetops and the branches, and Zariestra's there waiting for you, and then she turns and looks and picks out another path that heads into the willow branches, and you again slide into those, and a journey that should take you probably 2 or 3 days takes you 5 hours, right? And you emerge into these trees up at the top of
the edge of the forest. And what's remarkable to you is that for the first time since you entered the Ironwood, you can actually see the sky.
Oh, cool.
Like the silver mist kind of parts around you, and you can see, Kineas, thanks for the raid!
Thank you for the raid!
And you can see before you, you can see a valley that goes down, and up off to the right is the craggy slopes of Mount Hopno. And Zarastria turns to you.
Zarastria. No, you've always said it.
Zarastria?
Zariestra.
I was like, wait, none of these are right.
Zariestra.
My cold meds are wearing off.
I mean, can, like, while we're moving, are we able to, like, talk and, like, it's not, like, impeding this?
A little bit, yeah, if you want.
Okay, so I just... I'm not unattractive. Don't answer that. It's just, like, why would... He just, like, walked out. Like, he didn't say... It's so strange. I don't understand.
Strom is, like, kind of listening, but also just, like, the whole time just, like...
Yeah, it's fine. He doesn't want to
No, in our tribe, we have a range. There's a ranger since... It's just ever since the beginning, when you're...
It's like he has to know. Like, this is a once-in-a-lifetime for him, but this is, like, every day for me. So, like it's him that should be...
Should be what?
It should be. He should just be grateful, you know? I just feel like... You know, I'm doing.
Was he not grateful?
I was doing him a favor, really. If you think about it.
The way. You're very troubled, aren't you?
No, I'm perfectly fine.
You should smoke. I'm not gonna put it out.
Well, maybe when we stop running.
All right, very good. So you arrive at the top of this tree, and you're looking out over the valley down below. And Zariestra says, "Well, my friends, for now, this is where our paths part."
Strom hugs her.
Okay.
Or like her legs.
She instinctively waist. Like at first she sort of like flinches away, and then she realizes like, oh no, it's okay. And so she hugs you back. Mm-hmm. And she sort of pats you on the shoulder, and she looks at the bow that you've got slung over your back, and she's like, "Take good care of it."
It's a fine weapon.
Does it have a name?
I can't think of one off the top of my head right now. I'm sorry.
But it does.
Yeah, yeah. She says something in Elvish, which...
Oh, yeah, I guess. It doesn't translate.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
What's, like, the closest translation? Beanpole. Hard grass.
Stone of boundaries.
Like, I guess the easiest way to translate it is, like...
Bow tie.
Oh, geez, this kills real good, but it's not... It sounds so much better in Elvish. You know,
OMG.
Yeah.
What a metal bow.
Like, oh my god, isn't this such a good bow?
Oh. Yeah, so there's emotion behind it, too.
Yeah, yeah. It's like, it's not that, but like, it's the feeling of...
It's beautiful. Thank you. Well, won't be ours for much longer.
I want to approach Zariestra.
Mm-hmm.
You've given us so many nice gifts. I thought maybe I could give you one.
You gave us the gift of dispatching the waste lady.
Oh, right, but like a physical one to remember us by.
Yes.
And then I'm going to pull my my orb out. The orb that that
the
changes
drift
light.
Globe thing? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And hand that to her. It listens to you, and it'll follow you, and it changes to any color you're feeling or thinking.
And she lifts it, and it begins to, like, turn this sort of, like,
alternating kind of like bands of like green and yellow light, like almost like sunlight dappling through the trees, except it's coming from the orb. And then she gives like this spot on pitch perfect bird call whistle. And she says, I will not forget you, Strumthrum.
Nor will I you.
She takes a small ribbon of silk out of her hair and she hands it to you and she ties it around your wrist.
What color is it?
It is a bright yellow.
Now it's your turn to give her something back.
And she said,
I have something dead.
Kynaeus, thanks so much for the donation.
Thanks, Kynaeus!
And she says, if you ever find yourself in trouble, untie that knot. And you can look down and you can see that she's tied a very, like, somehow, like, incredibly quickly, she's tied a very complex Celtic knot in the silken ribbon that's around your wrist.
Thank you.
Nice.
I wish you well on your journeys. The druid is much like us. He is a bit of a loner. He views the ways through his, he views the world through his own particular philosophy of balance. It is not one that we agree with. It is somewhat off-putting, but these are off-putting and strange times. Perhaps you will be able to reach out to him and change his mind much in the same way that you've changed ours.
I hope so. Thank you so much. You're a people worth saving, and I love being part of your tribe, even for just a night.
Well, you have most of the afternoon ahead of you, but I suspect it will still take you till sundown to find the druid in his grove. I wish you the best on your journey, and I hope that we cross paths again soon.
That is tribe.
That is clan.
That is clan.
You descend down around the trunk of this large tree that you find yourself sort of perched in the top end of, and you reach the forest floor, and you travel not more than an hour, perhaps two, and the light of the afternoon is beginning to filter down through and set. It's nice to feel the warm rays of the sun on your face, but there is a certain stillness which settles into the forest, and you can tell as you must have crossed over some sort of invisible boundary, because the creatures of the forest go quiet. There are no bird calls, no crickets or insects.
It's like the fourth time that's happened to us.
And
it's never ended well.
No.
Suddenly you walk into this clearing and the trees turn from, you know, these giant elms and whatnot into pine trees and other evergreens. And before you stands this massive, almost like a sequoia type of pine, and it's got this enormous bushy green crown, and perched all over in the crown and hanging off of several lower branches and whatnot, you see 30 or 40 owls just sitting up in the top of this tree, staring down at you, blinking.
You know, I hear owls are quite stupid.
All right.
I can vouch for that.
You have found yourselves on the edge of the Druid's lands here in Coombe Cernant. Before we wrap things up for the evening, thank you to chat. We
yes.
have unlocked Amy's song. Ooh. For tonight.
Nice. I thought it was going to be level 5. That was a big battle.
That sure was a tough battle. Yeah,
it was
true.
Tough.
You
got
just leveled up to four like scared. 2 sessions ago.
I don't remember
ago.
That.
Yeah, it felt like
it was so long ago.
It was a whole season ago.
That's true.
Yeah, I don't like keeping track of that. I like keeping track of how leveled up I feel.
Okay.
Yeah.
And
I feel really adult right now.
Sure. Well, you were level 8, but then there was that big burst of necrotic energy. It's too bad that you're going to have to work your way back up.
Pretty well against the necrotic energy.
Let's see.
Do DMs laments rerolls transfer?
They do not.
Okay, and then... Hold on. Let's give this a shot.
Let's give it a shot.
I wrote a song. It's called Worthy.
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 Worthy. All right, let's hear it.
Someone's been saying that a lot. Okay. There's a man. I look to him to tell him. Oh, yeah. There's a man. I look. Oh, shit. Hold on. To tell me who I am and what does my life mean. He is wise, but there is a word he utilizes, and that word is worthy. He says if you're worthy in our clan, we fight for a title so we can be both friendly and rivals. Still thinking, what would our world be if the test weren't about if we're worthy? Then the shaman speaks and summons the quiet to think. He says, all you have to do is fight, all you have to do is try, all you have to do is never.
Very good. Hey, big thanks to everyone who subbed up or donated or retweeted the show or what have you. Your support is the only way we keep the lights on around here. So thank you so much, everyone, for tuning in this evening. Hey, big round of applause for Amy Vorpal.
Thank you. Thanks so much, chat, for tuning in.
We're 49 minutes away from Midnight Amy showing up, so we better, we gotta...
No, she can show up anytime of day she damn well places.
Witless Me, thanks for the bits.
Thank you, Witless Me.
Do you have anything else going on that you want to promo?
Not really. I have been streaming on my own channel, and that's really cool, but what I really want to say is it is so different streaming on your own channel, so I have a new appreciation for chat, because when you're doing it by yourself, you just... it's kind of like throwing a party and you like hope people show up. And then when they do, it just actually does mean quite a bit. So, you know, we've been streaming on other people's channels and Nerdist and Geek and Sundry and Saving Throw and all this. And it's not that I haven't appreciated it. I just have a new appreciation for all the people who continue to watch us and yeah, really chat in the community and hang out, like show up to the party, I guess. So it's very, very, it's yeah, I just newly am grateful for a chat.
Awesome. Awesome. Very good. Havana Mahoney, everyone.
Hi. Yeah, you can find me over on Twitch, here on Twitch, if you're not watching this on YouTube. I have a YouTube. It's all right.
Tell us a little bit about your Pugmire game that's coming up.
Yeah, I'm getting there. You interrupted my fucking job plug.
Sorry.
My full-time job plug. All right. Just wait a second.
Thank you, Pete Fairyman.
Yes, my full-time job that I do 6 days a week is streaming on my Twitch channel, which is twitch.tv/Vanna, V-A-N-A. So check me out over there. I do variety games and some role-playing sometimes, so come hang out. I have a super great community. They're fabulous, and you will be most welcome. Or you can follow me on Twitter to find about when I'm going live there or here or Geek and Sundry or Alpha. Mm-hmm. And that is twitter.com/HavanaRama, H-A-V-A-N-A. R-A-M-A, or you can catch the Pugmire game.
What?
I'm GMing.
What's that?
Here on Saving Throw Show. First episode is going to be October 9th. We're doing a 3-episode arc, and it's going to be every Tuesday. First episode's October 9th, and it's going to be great. I have the best cast. Amy Vorpal's on it. We also have Kelly Nugent. We have Kelly D'Angelo. And we have Omar Najam. So Ooh. It's going to be great. And yeah, Onyx Path is working with us on it, and they've been really amazing. And so it's just exciting to do some work with them and do some work with an amazing cast and do some work for all of you guys. So I hope you tune in for that. Mark your calendars with a little pug sticker. I know you all have a pug sticker.
Wow. Yeah, so. Out of those four players, who's going to do the weirdest accent?
I mean, historically, Amy, but...
Yeah, we don't know.
But Amy's a Shih Tzu. So.
Yeah, I was gonna say. Yeah. Do you know what breeds everybody's playing?
I'm playing Shih Tzu.
There's a Doberman, like a full size Doberman.
Yeah.
Is
yeah.
Kelly D'Angelo. And Omar.
I wouldn't put it past Kelly Nugent to like no. really surprise you with an accent.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. She is a voice actress, so yeah,
she might really go for it.
Yeah.
But I forget what breed her dog is. Oh, it's like a lab, right? It's a chocolate lab.
Oh, nice, fun. Maybe.
I think so. And then Kelly D'Angelo is a Doberman. Mm-hmm. And then Omar Najam is a Corgi. So it's going to be really great. It's going to be really
wow.
fun.
Wow. Well, I'm mad there's no Greyhounds. But we have enough Greyhounds on our show. So
oh, we really have, I would say, too many.
One too many.
He's being really good right now. Look at him.
Speaking of too many, we have one too many Erics on our show. Eric Reichard, everyone.
Stick burning.
Yeah, terrible troll.
This is how they're telling I'm being fired. You guys can check me out on
the Eric, I can't fire you. You're the only one who likes me on this show.
We like you. We just don't want you to ever be right or to win or to talk.
True. You can always follow me on the social medias at Mostly Shit. You can follow me on Twitch, where I do variety streaming in the afternoons on my Twitch channel, Mostly Eric. And you can catch me Tuesdays, the next 2 weeks, here on Saving Throw at 8 p.m. for the Garden of Good and Evil, which is our Changeling the Lost second edition game, where I play Sentient Mirror. So you can
is
watch
that your name?
No. I'm a sentient mirror.
Oh, that
like,
is...
Like, what size mirror? Like, a hand mirror?
No,
like
he's a full-size human person.
Some Beauty and the Beast shit.
But he...
Yeah.
He, yeah. His name is Musip Anderson Gladstone. It's a hyphenate.
Musip?
Yeah, Musip Anderson Gladstone.
That sounds very
He's
fun.
A sentient mirror.
I feel like there's more to this, but I can't put
names.
It together right now.
I just have an edit.
Yeah, go ahead.
On mine. Kelly Nugent is playing a Vizsla.
Oh.
A Vizsla. Oh, which is right. kind of like... a lab, but mixed with kind of like a...
One of my friends has a Vizsla. They're so spastic.
Really?
Like, I don't know how she's going to play it, but they're a dog that does not stop.
She's playing basically the equivalent, the Pugmire equivalent to like a paladin.
Yeah.
Okay. But she's also dressed like the Grim Reaper. I don't know. It's going to be great.
Super
it's
fun.
It's going to be great.
Let's have a big round of applause and thanks to Mr. Dom Zook, our illustrious
yes.
producer.
Dominic Theodore Zucker.
Helps keep everything running
as
here.
We all
and
know
who
I
has
love
been
him.
Very diligent lining up a number of exciting things for you. If you look at exclamation point calendar or if you've looked at any of the announcements recently.
Oh, yeah. I should plug that we've got Shadowrun on Monday.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
It's called Shadows on the Horizon, and Poizel is the GM.
That's right. That's right. We've got a new Shadowrun game coming. We've got a new D&D game coming in partnership with Wizards.
How dare they?
Based on Magic the Gathering, the new Ravnica book that they're putting out.
So I haven't. Lots... Please explain. Is it like Yu-Gi-Oh?
Well, you guys are more of a video game that turned into a card game.
Yeah, and there's no Shadowrun.
Oh my god!
It's like Hearthstone.
Pokemon training card game.
I love Hearthstone.
Sailor Moon training card game. Dragon Ball Z training card game.
Baseball.
Baseball!
Slide!
Ever heard of it?
Hey everyone, special thanks to our moderators who help keep the channel safe, friendly, clean, and accessible. Big shout out to DJ Regular, who is our clip master extraordinaire. Hopefully there's some good ones tonight.
I don't know, maybe don't put them, maybe don't. Maybe delete all the clips from tonight.
If you'd like to join in the conversation, you can jump on over to our Discord, where we have forums for everything, including this show and Disorganized Play, which is my DM prep show. Next week, I will be out of the hot seat. I will be in the cold, frozen north seat of Canada. Jay Africa will be back in
I'm
here.
I'm actually just GMing the Mamma Mia game again.
You know, if you want that to happen, we can make that happen.
No, we can't.
So Jay will be back. He'll be joining me on Tuesday at 2 o'clock for Disorganized Play, where we're going to talk about what's coming up in the next session, what he's got to prep, and what we can do to keep the story moving forward.
Cool.
Other than that, so coming up the rest of this week, Friday night at 8 o'clock, we've got another installment of Wild Cards, which is Deadlands Wild West show. So tune in for that. That is, I believe, episode 2, is that correct, of this current arc, which will be the last of the Wild West version. So tune in for that Friday at 8. Sunday at 1 o'clock, America's DM, David Crennan, will be back for another installment of Dungeon in a Box. That's Sunday at 1. Sunday at 5, what did we decide? North Hollywood GM Rick Budd is back for Tempting Fate. And then we turn around Monday night for Shadowrun. So tune in. We got a lot of stuff, a lot of exciting stuff on the calendar. So regardless of what game system you love, enjoy, indulge, want to see, I think we got a little something for everyone here on the Saving Throw Show. So thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you so much for your support and your retweets. Until next time, let's dungeon!